Boži blagoslov svima. Siguran sam da se osjećate bolje nego jučer i tjelesno, jel tako, odmorili ste se i duhovno nakon službe u zajedništvu. God bless you to everybody. I'm sure you feel better today than yesterday, both in your flesh, because you had some rest, and spiritually after the yesterday service. Imamo nekoliko najava. Prva je najava da svi stranci bi trebali dati pasoše ili lične karte bratu Želislavu Venarskom. Sad ako brat Želislav ustane, da oni koji ga ne znaju, evo brat Želislav je tu. Znači nakon službe svi stranci bi trebali dati osobne ili lične karte i pasoše tu bratu Želislavu. So we have some announcements. After this morning service, everybody should give his ID card or a passport to brother Želislav after this service. Onda imamo jedan mali prigovor. Primijetili su da su neki uzimali čebad ili deke vani na večer, ali te će se deke koristiti poslije za druge ljude koji spavaju i pokrivaju se, pa se to ne bi smjelo. Evo, ne znam ko je to bio, ali da se držimo tih pravila. To ne moram prevoditi na engleski. Onda još jedna stvar ovako. Zaključavat će se paviljoni nakon prije službe. I sad ćemo napraviti, odnosno tu je lista ljudi kod kojih će biti ključevi, tako da ako znate da tijekom službe trebate ići u neki od paviljona koji ima ključ za vaš paviljon. Onda ovaj prvi paviljon 1-1 će biti kod moje supruge, kod Ane, Ana Lerga. Drugi je paviljon kod brata, drugi je ključ za drugi paviljon, paviljon 1-2 kod brata Janka Tomaša. Treći paviljon ili 2-1 kod brata Papić Pere. I četvrti, zadnji onaj paviljon kod brata Keravice Darka. Oni imaju ključeve. Okay, so during the service we're gonna lock our pavilions. And here are the names of the brothers who and sisters who have a key. If you need during the service to go inside, you need to ask for a key for the first door. My wife has a key. For a second door, brother Janko Tomas has a key. For a third, brother Papić Pera. Everybody knows him. If there are strangers or foreigners in your pavilion. So this is the brother. And the last door, brother Keravica has a key. He sings for us, so you know who has a key. I još jedna najava. Sad ćete znat zašto je Janko meni dao da ovo pročitam. Kaže, nekakav je dogovor i težnja i cilj da se do 12 legne. Sad znate zašto, brat Janko. Možda nisam trebao to svima ni ispričati, nego samo ovima iz Europske unije, kaže Janko. Znači, iako pokušavate biti tihi, pričate dosta duboko i to sve od zadnja, zemlja se trese, vi to ne osjetite. Pa braća koja spavaju i ljudi koji imaju službe ujutro, malo je problem za zaspat, tako ako se toga pridržavamo. So the last announcement is that we are trying to have everybody in the bed at midnight. So till midnight we can have a fellowship, but after the midnight everybody should go to their room for people to get rest and for brothers who are preaching to be to have a rest and to be able to prepare themselves and so on. Evo na kraju. Brat Paljko, ja mislim da prošli put smo propustili bratu Paljku dati jedan pljesak za sam njegov trud i za sve što on napravio na ovom kampu, pa možda da mu damo sada pljesak i neka preuzme službu. Ja znam da brat Paljko dođe sa glasom, a ode bez glasa sa kampa svaki put. Potrudi se jako puno oko pjesama, oko muzike, oko slavljenja. Nije to lako, žrtvuje se, neka ga Gospod blagoslovi. Amen.
Hvala vam na podršci. Amen. I zato želim da zapevamo je prvu pesmu koja je meni jako draga. Pesma se zove Meni Isus je draži od sve, od srebra i od zlata. Amen.
pesmu zapevamo, jednako spre molitve. A onda bi zamolio brata Marka, samo ne mogu da ga vidim gde je. A nego se podigne ruku, bre, tu među nama iz Zagreba, da dođe da vodi molitvu, posle holosa, amen. Hajde da pevamo pesmu, ti si moj zakon, ti si moje utočište, kako se zove, ne znam. Samo znači ovo ćemo pojiti. Ti si moj zakon.
Shalom Aleichem. Amen.
Još jednu pesmu da se vraća, da li da vodi službe. On pozna ime mi, amen. Ja imam tu oca.
I have a Father.
Sing in your language.
He knows my heart. He knows my soul. My life is just
Oh,
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah.
Slava, slava.
Amen. It's so much of an honor for us to be with you today.
To je takva čast biti danas ovdje sa vama.
You have blessed our hearts.
Vi ste blagoslovili naša srca.
With your singing,
sa
with your worship.
Sa vašim pjevanjem, sa vašim proslavljanjem.
I came in here last night and you were already singing.
Došao sam jučer na večer.
And it just brought me to tears.
I jednostavno počeo sam plakati.
Someday in heaven.
Nekog dana u
nebu. We will sing.
Mi ćemo pjevati.
We will sing.
Mi ćemo pjevati.
And we will praise God.
I mi ćemo proslavljati Boga.
And this is just a small down payment.
I to je samo jedan predukus toga.
Of what we will all get to do someday, all the nations of the earth.
Što ćemo svi mi raditi, sve nacije ove zemlje.
All the different languages.
Svi različiti jezici.
All different stories.
Sve različite priče.
But one heart.
Ali jedno srce.
One purpose.
Jedna namjera.
One goal.
Jedan cilj.
Amen. Looking forward to that day.
Baš se veselim tome.
You may be seated for just
Možete
a moment.
Možete sjesti za trenutak.
Just want to say God richly, richly bless you.
Želim vam reći neka vas Bog bogato blagoslovi.
And we are honored to be here with you.
I počašćeni smo biti danas s vama.
We so wish I could spend time with everyone.
Tako želim da bi mogao provesti neko vrijeme sa svakim od vas.
Have good fellowship with each and every one of you.
Da bi imao lijepo zajedništvo sa svakim od vas.
And my so glad my wife sister Sarah came with us.
I tako sam veseo da i moja supruga sestra Sara došla sa mnom.
Sometimes people say, Brother Eugene, you have a worldwide ministry.
Nekad ljudi kažu, brate Eugene, ti imaš službu po cijelom svetu.
So I tell them, no, I have a strong home ministry, and it's with my wife.
Ne, ja kažem, ja imam snažnu kućnu službu i to je sa mojom suprugom.
Amen. And I'm really privileged and glad to have some very special friends here, Brother Dale and Brother Dwayne and their wives here.
I stvarno sam počašćen da imamo sa sobom i moje drage prijatelje, brata Dale i brata Dwayna sa njihovim suprugama.
I really do believe that in America they are the two best evangelists that all America has, and they serve God faithfully.
Ja stvarno vjerujem da su to dvojica najboljih evangelista u Americi i verno služe Bogu.
And I have been so blessed by their ministries.
Ja sam bio stvarno tako blagoslovljen njihovom službom.
Sister Sarah and I took a holiday this summer. Brother Dale and Sister Joanne came and took over the church for a month.
Sestra Sara i ja smo uzeli odmora ovoga leta i brat Dale i njegova supruga sestra Joanne su došli i jednostavno nadomestili nas.
And the church certainly was blessed by both of them.
I crkva je stvarno bila blagoslovljena od obojice njih.
We run a youth camp every year, and Brother Dwayne comes to preach at our youth camp this last time. Brother Dwayne came.
Svake godine imamo kamp za mlade i sad ovaj zadnji put došao je brat Dwayne.
And we had a wonderful move of the Holy Spirit.
Imali smo jedan odličan pomak Duha Svetoga, djelovanje Duha Svetoga.
And what we didn't know was that a few months later some of those children were going to die in a plane wreck.
I ono što nismo znali je bilo to da će neke od tih djece sa kampa za nekoliko mjeseci umreti u avionskoj nesreći.
So we're thankful to God that he takes care of his own.
I tako smo zahvalni Bogu da se on pobrine za svoje.
And I want to ask you that you don't know what tomorrow holds either.
I ja vam želim pitati, dakle ni vi ne znate što za vas donosi sutrašnji dan.
And if the Lord moves on your heart.
I ako Bog napravi pomak na vaše, da ako se dotakne vašeg srca,
this may be your opportunity to face what's coming down the road 2 weeks from now.
To može biti možda vaša prilika da se onda sretnete s njim za 2 tjedna.
I have never met the brother. He's from Italy.
Brother Mariano.
Mariano.
Ja, brat Mariano, ja ga nisam sreo, on je iz Italije.
Where are you?
Gdje si, brat? Oh, yeah. Third row.
Ah, stand up.
Molim te, ustani.
God bless you.
Amen.
Amen. There's a brother in our church. When I just took over the church, we had much to do with Brother Mariano.
Postoji jedan brat, kada sam ja preuzeo pastorstvo u crkvi, bio jedan brat, imali smo puno zajedničko sa bratom
Marijanom. Stefan Hagen would certainly love to have coffee with you.
I brat Stefan Hagen, to je taj brat, bi sigurno želio popiti kafu s tobom.
Amen. And to all you ministering brothers, I just want to say that we're humbled to be here. You could certainly stand behind these pulpits and minister also. We would all be blessed.
I svi vi ostali propovednici, mi smo zaista privilegirani da smo tu sa vama. Svako od vas bi mogao stajati za ove propovednice i mi bi svi bili blagoslovljeni.
And we certainly want to respect the gift of God in your life as well.
I isto tako želimo biti zahvalni, odnosno poštivati Božji dar u vašim životima također.
Amen. God bless you.
Neka vas Bog blagoslovi.
I'd like to know something. How many people here have been in the message less than 5 years?
Želim znati nešto. Koliko od vas tu je u poruci manje od 5 godina? Podignite
raise your hands.
Podignite
oh, my. God richly bless you.
Neka vas Bog bogato blagoslovi.
You're in for a wonderful time.
Vi ste tu da doživite jedno divno vrijeme.
It's a life by faith.
Znači, život po vjeri.
With a purpose.
Sa namjerom, sa ciljem.
And it's you never know what tomorrow holds.
I nikad ne znate što ima za vas sutra, sutrašnji dan.
I came to the message in 1977.
Ja sam došao u poruku 1977. godine.
And many people left the message at that time.
I u to vrijeme puno ljudi je napustilo poruku.
When they left the door open.
I kada su odlazili, ostavili su vrata otvorena.
And God called me in.
A Bog je pozvao mene.
And it has been the best thing that ever happened to me. I'm the only one in my family that's in the message. Out of 8 children, I'm the only one.
I to je najbolja stvar koja mi se desila u životu. Ja sam jedini od 8 djece u mojoj obitelji koje sam u poruci.
So if there's some people here that you're the only one that's God saved out of the family, God bless you. I know exactly how that feels.
I ako je možda tu netko da ste jedini u svojoj familiji da vas je Bog spasio, neka vas Bog blagoslovi. Ja znam yeah. Kako je to.
But I want to remind you.
Ali želim vas podsjetiti.
That God wants to save your family.
Da Bog želi spasiti vašu familiju.
And he has chosen you to do it through.
Amen. I on je izabrao vas da to napravi kroz vas.
You are God's agent to your family.
Vi ste Božji agent za vašu familiju.
Now remember Lot, he went to Sodom.
I sad pomislite, Lot je otišao u Sodomu.
He didn't have the faith to live a Christian life.
On nije imao vjeru da živi kršćanskim životom.
But he received righteousness because he believed what happened to Abraham.
Ali on je primio pravednost zbog toga što je vjerovao onome što se dogodilo Abrahamu.
And the Bible calls Lot righteous Lot.
I Biblija zove Lota pravedni Lot.
But really he was living off of the righteousness of Abraham.
Ali zaista on je živio od pravednosti Abrahama.
So someday God might call your family righteous.
I jednog dana Bog može nazvati tvoju familiju pravednu.
But that's only because their righteousness is actually your righteousness.
Ali to samo zbog toga jer će biti njihova pravednost zapravo tvoja vlastita pravednost.
So when you retell the stories of the prophet,
i onda ako prepričamo te priče koje je govorio prorok,
and retell what God did for you,
i onda prepričate ono što je Bog napravio za vas,
take heart.
Onda budite hrabri.
Your family is depending on you.
Vaša obitelj je ovisi o tome.
For their salvation.
Znači njihovo spasenje.
Just a little bit of background history.
Samo da dam još malo prošlosti, znači nekakav background, odnosno
I was temel. Not raised in the message.
Ja nisam bio, dakle nisam odrastao u poruci.
I had an experience with God at 16.
Imao sam iskustvo s Bogom kad sam imao 16 godina.
And then I went to church to try to find God, and then I quit church because I couldn't find God anymore.
I onda sam išao u crkvu da bi našao Boga i onda sam odustao od crkve jer tamo nisam našao Boga.
And I just lived in the world for about 4 years.
I onda sam živio nekako u svijetu nekih 3-4 godina.
And then one day I started courting my, which is now my wife's sister Sarah.
I jednog dana sam počeo, ajmo reći, ići na izlaske sa djevojkom koja je danas moja supruga, sestra Sara.
And at that time Sarah's father had just received a tract against the message.
I baš u to vrijeme njezin otac je primio traktat koji je govorio protiv poruke.
And so then he went and got a church age book and a seals book.
I onda je išao i nabavio sedam crkvenih doba i sedam pečata knjigu.
And I remember the first time I met him.
I sećam se prvi put kad sam ga sreo.
He was sitting at a table.
On je seo za stolom.
His back, he was full of arthritis. He was very sick.
Da, on je bio jako bolestan, bio je artritičan.
But he had a Bible.
Ali imao je Bibliju.
A church age book.
Knjigu sedam crkvenih doba. I knjigu sedam pečata.
And me, just being kind to her father,
i ja sam samo želio biti pristojan.
I would sit down with him and talk about what he wanted to talk about.
I ja sam samo seo i onda pričao ono o čemu je on želio da priča.
And what he was doing is trying to prove the prophet wrong.
I ono što je on pokušavao je da dokaže da prorok nije bio u pravu.
Because the prophet was a false prophet.
Jer je prorok bio lažni prorok.
And he had the seals book.
Imao je knjigu pečata.
And he had his Bible.
Imao je svoju Bibliju.
And the more he realized,
i više je upoznavao,
that God had sent a prophet.
Da je Bog sve više i više doznavao da je Bog zaista poslao proroka.
And he didn't know anything.
I on nije znao ništa.
So I would come and sit down with him.
Tako da sam ja dolazio i sjeo bi s njim.
And talk about baptism.
I govorio o krštenju.
I didn't care nothing for baptism.
Meni je bilo svejedno u vezi krštenja.
But when he spoke.
Ali kad je on govorio.
And read the prophet's quote.
I čitao prorokove citate.
Something deep inside of me.
Nešto duboko u meni.
Something I did not know was there.
Nešto što ja nisam znao da uopšte postoji tamo.
Started to respond.
Počelo je odgovarati,
and
odazivati
I enjoyed
se.
It.
I ja sam uživao u
and
tome.
It moved me.
I to me je pokretalo.
It gave me direction.
To mi je dalo pravac.
It gave me purpose.
Dalo mi je, znači, smisao.
When he read about serpent seed.
Kada je on čitao o zmićevom semenu.
Something deep inside of me.
Nešto duboko u meni.
Said, that's right.
I reklo, to je istina, to je tako.
And what I didn't know,
i ono što ja nisam znao,
that God was calling my name.
Da je Bog dozivao moje ime. Amen.
He didn't say, Eugene.
On nije rekao, Eugene.
He said, here's the mystery.
On je rekao, tu je tajna.
And I was responding to the mystery.
I ja sam se odazivao toj tajni.
And that was the father calling the prodigal son back home.
I to je bio otac koji je dozivao izgubljenog sina da se vrati kući. Amen.
So this message is different.
Dakle, ova poruka je nešto drugčija.
In that it calls the inside first.
Da u biti ona prvo doziva ono unutrašnje.
Doesn't matter what you look like on the outside.
Nije bitno kako ti izgledaš izvana.
But as you feed on the word,
ali kako se ti hraniš riječju,
then the outside starts to change.
Onda se i vanjskost počinje mijenjati.
And so by God's grace I married my wonderful princess.
I tako Božjom milošću ja sam se venčao za moju divnu princesu.
We got baptized the same day, the same place, at the same time.
Mi smo bili kršteni istog dana na istom mjestu u isto vrijeme.
And then after that we got married.
I onda posle toga mi smo se venčali.
And then God has blessed us with 4 children.
I onda nas je Bog blagoslovio sa 4 djece.
3 daughters,
3 čerke i jednog sina.
They're all serving the Lord faithfully.
I svi verno služe Bogu.
And I had no idea ever that I'd be a pastor. That's not what I wanted. I wanted to be a farmer.
I ja nikad nisam imao ideju da ću postati pastor. To ja nikad nisam želio. Ja sam želio biti samo farmer.
I have wanted to quit many, many, many times.
I često puta, mnogo puta sam hteo odustati.
I've always said, God, there must be a better man. I'm not good enough.
Rekao sam, Bože, pa mora postojati bolji čovjek od mene. Ja nisam dovoljno dobar.
But yet,
ali ipak,
through it all,
kroz sve to,
by faith,
vjerom,
We've been able to serve God the best I know how.
Mi smo bili u mogućnosti služiti Bogu na najbolji način koji ja znam.
Amen. So let's stand this morning or this
Ustanimo
morning
ovoga jutra.
How do I know what time it is?
Koje je vrijeme?
Give me a clock. Turn with me if you would to 1 Corinthians 4. Time is running away. It's 11 o'clock. It's 5, yeah. 10 to 11. We're having dinner at 10, right? 12?
Yeah.
Oh, my,
no,
my.
No, at 1.
When is dinner?
At 1. 1? One? 1 in 2 hours. Okay. Yeah. We have plenty of time. Prva Korinčanima.
I'd like to take the thought this morning.
Želio bi uzeti ovoga jutra misao.
On staying and keeping honor under the sixth seal.
Znači, ostati i zadržati poštovanje pod šestim pečatom.
Because we're living in a day and age when there's many people are losing their honor serving God. They're serving God, but they're finding themselves out of honor.
Jer živimo u danima kada vidimo da mnogi ljudi gube poštovanje, odnosno čast služeći Bogu. Znači, oni želi služiti Bogu, ali izgube čast.
All right, so we'll read first from 1 Corinthians 4.
Dakle, prvo ćemo čitati iz 1 Korinčanima 4.
And if you'll read from verses 1 to 3, and then I'll pray.
Okay. Čitat ćemo od 1. do 3. stiha. Kaže ovako, neka nas ljudi smatraju službenicima Kristovim i upraviteljima tajna Božjih. Povrh toga, od upravitelja se zahtjeva da budu vjerni. Ali meni nimalo nije do toga da me sudite vi ili ljudski sud, jest ni ja sam sebe ne sudim.
Heavenly Father,
nebeski Oče,
this is always the nervous time, Lord, if you'll come.
Ovo je uvek ovo nervozno vrijeme da li ćeš ti doći.
These people are your purchase of the blood of your blood.
Ovi ljudi su otkupljeni tvojom krvlju.
And we're very mindful.
I mi se zaista
as ministers.
Toga smo svjesni kao Božji službenici.
Of our responsibility to your bride.
Naše odgovornosti tvojoj nevesti.
Anoint the ministry, Father, this morning and the here also.
Blagoslovi Božje službenike i one koji slušaju ovog jutra.
May something of the word become real.
Neka nešto od ove reči postane realnost.
That's my request, Father.
To je moja želja, to ja molim.
Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
Neka vas Bog blagoslovi.
God bless you. May be seated.
Možete sjesti.
This scripture verse that I read,
znači ovo pismo koje smo čitali,
I want to take one word out of there, and that's the word stewards.
Želim uzeti jednu reč iz toga, a to je reč upravitelj.
Now, a steward doesn't mean a possessor.
Znači upravitelj nije onaj koji nešto drži u vlasništvu.
For instance,
na primjer,
I pastor a church in Edmonton, Canada.
Ja sam pastor crkve u Edmontonu u Kanadi.
But that's not my church.
Ali to nije moja crkva.
I'm only a steward of what God has possessed.
Ja sam samo upravitelj onoga čega je vlasnik Bog.
So I have a responsibility.
Tako da ja imam odgovornost
to God,
Bogu,
for the way he would want his possession.
Dakle, za ono kako on želi upravljati tom svojim vlasništvom.
I have no right.
Ja nemam nikakvog prava
to take and run the church my way.
Da bi sad uzeo i upravljao tu crkvu na moj način.
For my purpose.
Za neki moju namjeru, odnosno cilj.
Because the church is a stewardship that does not belong to me.
Jer crkva je zapravo upraviteljstvo koje ne pripada meni.
Okay, now.
Da li razumem?
This body,
dakle ovo telo,
does not belong to me.
Ne pripada meni.
It's a temple.
To je hram.
We have a stewardship.
I mi imamo upraviteljstvo.
To carry this body,
da nosimo ovo telo,
that it reflects him.
Koje reflektira njega, odnosno da reflektira njega.
Right?
Da li ti je tako?
That's why I don't put tattoos on my arm.
Zato ja ne stavljam tatuje na moju ruku.
I don't put an earring in my ear.
Ne stavljam naušnice u svoje uši.
Because I have a stewardship.
Jer imam upraviteljstvo
as a temple.
Nad tim hramom.
Okay? My wife.
Moja supruga
is a stewardship.
Ona je dio tog upraviteljstva.
She is a daughter of God first.
Ona je prvo kćer Božja.
Wife second.
Onda drugo je žena.
Not wife first.
Nije ona prvo žena.
And daughter of God second.
Znači, supruga i onda Božja čerka.
Us husbands have a stewardship.
Znači, mi supruzi imamo upraviteljstvo.
To treat her as a daughter of God.
Da je tretiramo kao Božju čerku.
My children are not mine.
Moja deca nisu moja.
They're not my children.
Oni nisu moja deca.
God has borrowed them to me for a while.
Bog mi ih je posudio za određeno vreme.
To give back to God.
Da ih ja vratim Bogu. Amen.
So, to be a steward,
dakle biti upravitelj,
you've got to be found faithful.
Ti moraš biti prepoznat kao da si veran.
That means sometimes we do things that it's not natural for us, but we do things for God's glory.
Dakle, mi ponekad radimo neke stvari koje možda nisu u našoj prirodi, ali to radimo na slavu Božju.
Okay, so now in this end time message,
i tako u ovoj poruci posljednjeg vremena,
because God has given us an extra level of faith,
jer nam je Bog dao neki dodatni nivo vere,
because
zbog toga da,
this is the only generation,
jer je to ova jedina generacija,
that will take on a translation,
koja će doživjeti translaciju, znači prenos,
not a resurrection,
ne ustanak.
There are some of us,
znači neki od nas,
that may go through a resurrection,
mogu ići kroz ustanak,
but I'm sitting today with some of us,
ali ja sedim danas sa nekim od
nas, that we will go into a translation,
koji ćemo ići u, znači u prenos na drugu stranu,
which means that God's going to have to provide an extra measure of faith.
A to znači da će Bog morati dati jednu određenu dodatnu meru vere
for a translation,
za taj prenos.
All right? So the message is a stewardship.
I dakle, poruka je upraviteljstvo.
And the message is not our message.
I poruka nije naša poruka.
It's God's message.
Nego je to Božja poruka.
And we have an honor to we have to, in order to stay in honor.
I sada s namjerom da ostanemo u toj časti,
we have to remember that we have to in order to stay in honor, we've got to take the message and treat it with godly care. Mm-hmm. Let's put it that way.
Da. Dakle, da bi mi ostali u časti, mi moramo uzeti tu poruku i tretirati je na pravilni, na Božji način.
Now Paul,
i sada Paul
had a very specific position.
On je imao jednu veoma specifičnu poziciju.
For instance,
na primjer,
Paul was not in the upper room.
Paul nije bio u gornjoj sobi.
Paul didn't go fishing with Jesus.
On nije išao na ribarenje sa Isusom.
Paul never saw the Son of Man ministry the way the disciples did.
On nikad nije video službu Sina Božjega na način, odnosno Sina čovječeg na način kako što je video Petar.
But Paul, because he met the cloud, the pillar of fire,
ali pošto je on, znači Pavle, vidio oblak, vidio je ognjeni stup,
and the pillar of fire had a voice,
i ognjeni stup imao je glas,
and the pillar of fire held a revelation,
i ognjeni stup je imao u sebi otkrivenje,
that Paul needed,
koje je trebalo Paulu,
to tell the disciples,
da kaže onda učenicima,
what they had lived through,
kroz što su oni proživjeli.
Now think.
Sad pomislite.
The disciples had lived through a Son of Man ministry.
Znači, učenici su živjeli kroz tu službu Sina čovječeg.
But didn't have a full revelation what it was all about.
Ali nisu imali punog otkrivenja o čemu je tu bilo, o čemu se radilo.
But Paul,
ali Pavle,
not one of the disciples,
on nije bio jedan tih učenika,
not on the day of Pentecost,
nije bio na danu Pentakosta,
had the revelation from the cloud
je imao iz oblaka otkrivenje
that the disciples needed koji, to understand what was happening to them.
Koji su učenici trebali da bi uopće shvatili šta im treba.
So Paul
i tako je Pavle
had an authority,
ima autoritet,
a revelation,
ima otkrivenje
that the others didn't have,
koji ostali nisu imali.
And so Paul could say,
i tako je Pavle mogao reći,
though an angel preached any other gospel than what I preach,
ako bi čak anđeo došao i propovedao neko drugo evanđelje koje sam ja propovedao,
let him be accursed,
neka bude proklet.
That's a bold statement.
To je jako hrabra izjava.
But Paul,
ali Pavle,
was in honor,
imao je tu čast,
to what the cloud revealed,
da vidi ono što je oblak otkrio.
In this day,
i u ovom danu,
we've had a prophet,
imali smo proroka,
with a son of man ministry,
koji je, znači, imao službu sina čovječeg,
but the cloud held the revelation,
ali oblak je sadržavao to otkrivenje,
of what the son of man ministry was doing,
onoga što služba sina čovječeg radi.
And we've had a ministry,
imali smo službu,
that could say,
koja je mogla reći,
as Paul said,
kao što je Pavle rekao,
according to my gospel,
u skladu sa mojim evanđeljem,
biće
ustanak, uskrsnuće.
So we're in a wonderful spot today.
Dakle, mi smo na jednom divnom mjestu danas.
You don't have to wonder which baptism is right.
Vama ne treba se pitati koje krštenje je pravilno.
You don't have to wonder about serpent seed.
Ne treba se pitati o zmićevom semenu.
You don't have to wonder.
Ne trebate se pitati
about how to dress.
Kako se oblačiti.
Because we've had a prophet.
Jer smo imali proroka.
Go to heaven.
Koji je otišao na nebo.
And tell us how they dress in heaven.
I rekao nam kako su obučeni
so
oni u
heavenly beings,
i ako smo mi nebeska bića,
then our heart draws to heaven,
onda je naše srce privučeno onome što je na nebu.
Amen.
Amen.
What a good place to be.
Kako odlično mjesto da
budemo. What a wonderful place to be.
Kako odlično mjesto.
Turn with me to first 2 Timothy chapter 2.
Otvorimo zajedno 2 Timotej, druga glava.
The word honor,
znači ova reč čast,
is a special word,
to je jedna posebna reč,
in that it designates,
koja posebna je zbog toga jer ona označava
staying in subject to a certain authority.
Znači ona označava, odnosno ona obuhvaća u sebi značenje da mi ostajemo podložni određenom autoritetu.
Okay. Now let's say that brother Uroš, he's a general.
Recimo da je brat Uroš general.
And I'm just a soldier came off of the field.
I ja sam jedan vojnik koji je došao sa polja, bojnog
and
polja.
I do something heroic.
I ja napravim nešto herojsko.
To save the men in the field.
Recimo spasio sam neke ljude tamo na bojištu.
So then to award me,
i tako da me on nagradi,
the general or the authorities,
general, odnosno taj autoritet,
they have the ability to bestow honor on me,
oni imaju tu mogućnost da mi iskažu tu čast,
and they give me a badge to reflect that honor,
i daju nekakvu medalju koju reflektira tu čast.
So to be an honor,
i dakle da ja mogu biti u toj časti,
you have to be subject to a higher authority to receive honor.
Dakle, ti moraš biti podređen jednoj višoj autoriteti od koje ti primaš tu čast.
And so we're finding now that Paul he wants to make sure that the ministry and the people that they stay in honor to the authority which is God's word.
I tako vidimo da Pavle pokuša ljude dovesti do toga da bi oni ostali živjeti u toj časti koja im je dodeljena od te više autoritete.
And living under the sixth seal,
i živjeti pod šestim pečatom,
where all the other seals have opened,
gdje su i svi ostali pečati otvoreni,
there is a very high degree of dishonor.
Postoji jedna veoma visoki nivo beščašća.
And let me say it like this.
I nek ajmo reći na taj način.
What we call the message,
ono što mi nazivamo poruka,
is actually God calling his son and daughter.
Je u stvari pozivanje Boga, to da Bog poziva svoju čer i svog sina,
to their adopted place,
u svoje posinovljeno mjesto.
Now, Many men when they came to the message, like it was in Jesus's time.
Tako sada puno ljudi koji su došli u poruku kao što je to bilo u Isusovo vrijeme.
They thought it was a movement.
Oni su mislili da je to nekakav pokret.
And I'm going to a message church because many people go there.
I sad ja ću ići u crkvu poruke jer puno ljudi tamo
ide. And it's getting bigger and bigger and bigger.
I ona je sve veća i sve veća i sve veća.
So they want to be part of a movement.
I oni su željeli biti dio tog pokreta.
But by the time God's done,
ali do kraja, do momenta kada je Bog završio
s tim, gonna find this is not a movement.
Vi ćete saznati da to nije nikakav pokret.
And they will be gone.
I oni će u biti otići.
And then there's men that became very rich materially because of the message.
I onda postoje ljudi koji su postali veoma bogati i to bogati u materijalnom smislu zbog poruke.
But that's also not the purpose of the message.
Ali to isto tako nije namjera poruke.
And then there's men that wanted to be popular.
I onda postoje ljudi koji su željeli postati popularni.
They wanted to have a crowd around them.
Oni su uvijek željeli biti okruženi mnoštvima.
That only lasted for a little while.
I to je trajalo samo kratko vrijeme.
And then that all came down also.
I onda se i to srušilo.
Because God is not interested in a big crowd.
Jer Boga ne zanima veliko mnoštvo.
He's not interested in a big building.
On njega ne zanimaju velike zgrade.
He's not interested in a movement.
Njega ne zanima pokret.
He is interested in his son and his daughter.
On je zainteresiran za svog sina i za svoju kćer.
And to call them back home.
I da njih pozove kući.
So now Paul in 2 Timothy here.
I tako Pavle u 2. Timoteju.
And verse 1 he says,
u prvom redu.
There's many many things here, but verse 1 he says, thou therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus, and these things that thou hast learned of me among many witnesses, the same, and commit them also to faithful men who shall be able to teach others.
Znači, to je druga poslanica Timoteju 2.1. Ti stoga, sine moj, budi jak u milosti koja je u Kristu Isusu, i ono što si od mene čuo među mnogim svjedocima, predaj vernim ljudima koji će biti sposobni i druge poučiti.
So now there has to be that faithfulness come down to men.
Znači, sad mora biti ta vernost koja silazi na ljude.
And then in the third verse he says, now therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ.
I onda u trećem stihu kaže, ti se stoga zlo pati kao dobar vojnik Isusa Krista. Znači,
now let me tell you a little bit about that endure hardness as a good soldier.
I sada, pazite, neka vam malo dublje kažem šta znači zlopatiti kao dobar vojnik.
If you're called to be a soldier in an army,
ako si ti pozvan da budeš vojnik u armiji,
the enemy,
znači suprotnik,
is not that hard to identify.
Njega nije tako teško identificirati.
And you need a sense of good hardness to face the enemy.
I ti trebaš u biti jedan veliki mjer neke zlopatnosti da ti možeš to izdržati.
But to be a good soldier, to endure hardness also means to endure your own army when all the things go wrong in your own army.
Ali to ne znači samo znači suočiti se sa svojim protivnikom, nego izdržati to znači i da se ti može suočiti sa svim lošim stvarima koji se nameću unutar tvoje vlastite armije.
Because so often in an army,
jer tako često u vojsci,
you have two captains,
ti imaš recimo dva kapetana,
competing with each other,
koji takmiče međusobno,
and just to compete,
i samo zbog tog takmičarstva,
they'll send soldiers,
oni će poslati vojnike
to their death,
u njihovu smrt,
not thinking,
ne da bi razmišljali.
So often in your own army,
i tako često u svojoj vlastitoj vojsci,
they tell the soldiers, go out to the river and camp there.
Oni kažu vojnicima, idite tamo do reke i ukampirajte se tamo.
But they didn't tell the Air Force.
Ali oni onda zaboravaju reći to vazduhoplovstvu.
Right? So the Air Force is coming.
I onda vazduhoplovstvo dolazi.
And they think that you're enemy.
I oni misle da si ti njihov protivnik.
And then they're bombing you. Your planes are bombing you.
I onda tvoji vlastiti avioni bombardiraju tebe.
And then as a soldier,
i onda ti kao vojnik,
you say, that's it.
Ti kažeš, pa dobro, dosta.
This is ridiculous.
Pa to je strašno, to je smiješno.
I quit.
Ja odustajem.
And the tendency is to quit.
I naravno, tebe vuče na to da bi odustao.
And then sometimes a soldier sent out to war in a certain place.
I onda ponekad vojnik koji je poslan na određeno mjesto u ratu.
And he grabs all the ammunition with him to go fight.
I on uzme svu tu municiju da ide da se bori.
And then when he gets there,
i onda kad dođe tamo,
he throws the bullet in his gun,
on baci metak u pušku,
and he pulls the trigger,
i on potegne obarač,
and it goes click,
i onda kaže klik,
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 klik.
Somebody back there,
znači netko tamo u pozadini,
forgot to put the primer in the bullet to shoot the bullet.
Je zaboravio staviti pravu municiju u te kese da bi mogli se pucati.
And now your life is in danger because somebody there didn't give you the right stuff.
I sada si ti tamo u opasnosti zbog toga jer neko tamo u pozadini tebi nije dao pravu stvar.
So Paul says,
i tako Pavle kaže,
endure hardness.
Znači izdržite to, zlopatite. Zlopati to, znači izdrži to, Timotiju to rekao.
Because there'll be many things go wrong.
Jer puno će stvari krenuti naopako.
And Timothy,
i Timothy,
you'll have men in your ranks.
Ti ćeš imati ljude među u vašem krugu
that are like Phlegmidas and those men.
Koji su kao da, Phlegmidas i te ljudi.
And they're sowing discord.
I oni u biti siju nered.
They're destroying faith.
Oni ruše veru.
And Timothy, they're in your camp.
I Timothy tamo u tvom kampu.
But listen, Timothy.
Ali slušaj, Timoteju.
You endure hardness as a good soldier.
Ti izdrži to zlopati kao dobar vojnik.
And by faith.
I po veri.
Move on.
Idi, kreni
and
dalje.
And know who your real captain is.
I znaj tko je tvoj stvarni kapetan.
And we're living in a day and age.
I mi sada živimo u danu
in the hardening of the soldier.
Znači, kada se ti vojnici, znači, sad ohrabruju, odnosno učvršuju.
Because many things are coming our way we would have never dreamt ever would have come our way.
Jer dolaze nam put stvari o kojima mi nekada uopće nismo ni pomislili da mogu doći.
Amen, understand,
amen.
Right?
Da li razumemo? Amen, želim da je to jasno.
I want to make it very clear.
Želim da je to potpuno jasno.
Sometimes you hear, Brother Eugene, I went to this church for many years.
Možete čuti. Možete čuti, brate Eugene, znaš, ja sam nekada išao mnogo godina u tu crkvu.
And all those years I was faithful, I paid my tithes.
I sve ove godine ja sam bio veran, plaćao sam desetak.
And the end of it, the pastor was an adulterer.
I na kraju sam doznao da je pastir bio preljubnik.
And he left.
I on je otišao.
And so then you start to see that there's a disparaging of the purpose. The purpose of his life is being, his faith is being hindered.
Dakle, i sad vidimo da je dakle bila njegova vera time povređena. Smisao njegovog života, njegova vera je bila povređena.
But let me encourage you.
Ali daj da vas ohrabri.
Have faith.
Imajte veru.
Move on.
I krenite dalje.
One person told me one time, I've been hurt by so many ministers.
Jedna osoba mi je jednom rekla, ja sam bio povređen od toliko propovednika.
So I told him,
ja sam mu rekao,
well, I've never been hurt by any church members.
Oh, ja nisam bio nikad povređen nikakvim crkvenim članovima.
It's an amazing thing.
Zanimljiva je stvar.
Turn with me to verse 8.
Pogledajmo u 8. stihu, dakle 2. Timoteja
2:8. Second Timothy 2 verse 8. Remember that Jesus Christ of the seed of David was raised from the dead according to my gospel.
Spomini se da je Isus Krist od sjemena Davidova uskrsnuo od mrtvih po mojem evanđelju.
And there you also realize that Paul was so sure.
I tako vidimo da je Pavle bio tako siguran
of the pillar fire that he met on the road to Damascus.
Znači o tom ognjenom stupu kojeg je on sreo na putu za Damask.
And when the voice spoke out of the cloud,
i kada je taj glas progovorio iz tog oblaka,
he said, "Hey Paul."
On je rekao, "Hey Pavle."
Isn't it hard for you to kick against the pricks?
Zar nije teško tebi ići protiv Bogu?
And he has this conversation, who are you, Lord?
I on je tu pričao s njim, tko si ti, Gospode?
And I am Jesus who you persecuted.
Ja sam Isus, taj kojega ti progoniš.
What Paul was lacking in his religion,
ono što je Paulu falilo u njegovoj religiji,
the cloud supplied by revelation,
to je ono, znači to mu je dao oblak kroz otkrivenje.
And when Paul was finished meeting the cloud,
i kada je Pavle završio taj posjet oblaka,
he went back.
On je otišao,
and he took the Bible,
i uzeo je Bibliju,
and he started flipping back and forth in the Bible to make sure that his revelation was correct from the Old Testament.
I onda je počeo pretraživati simo i tamo kroz celu Bibliju da vidi, da bude siguran da je otkrivenje koje je primio točno.
And when Paul realized,
i kada je Pavle shvatio,
that Jesus Christ was the same yesterday, today and forever,
da je Isus Krist isti jučer, danas i za uvijek,
he brought the scripture back to life one more time.
On je ponovo doneo to pismo u život.
And with that revelation,
i sa tim otkrivenjem,
he could open the doors for the Gentile bride.
On je mogao otvoriti vrata paganskoj nevesti
for the seven church ages,
za doba sedam crkvenih doba.
That would become a standard to measure by.
Znači, koje će postati standard prema kome će se mjeriti.
So then Paul,
i tako je Pavle,
he could boldly say,
on je hrabro mogao reći,
that Jesus Christ was resurrected according to my gospel.
Da je Isus Krist bio uskrsnut u skladu sa mojim evanđeljem.
But then he warns going ahead,
ali onda kaže, on je upozorava i ide dalje.
And read from verse 19.
I čitat ćemo od 19. do 21.
2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 19 to 21.
Znači, druga poslanica Timoteju 2 od 19 do 21 kaže ovako: ipak temelj Božji stoji čvrsto imajući ovaj pečat. Poznaje Gospodin one koji su njegovi i neka odstupi od nepravde svatko tko imenuje ime Kristovo. A u velikoj kući nema samo zlatnih i srebrnih posuda, nego i drvenih i zemljanih. I jedne su za ono časno, a drugo su za nečasno. Ako se stoga tko očisti od toga, bit će posuda na čast, posvećena i korisna gospodaru, pripravna za svako dobro djelo.
So you, now you understand that in every household that's built.
Znači, sad vidite, u svakoj kući koja je izgrađena,
looking forward,
gledamo dalje,
there was going to be vessels of honor and vessels of dishonor.
Znači, bit će posude za čast i bit će posude za nečast.
Watch this.
Gledaj sad ovo.
In God's house.
U Božoj kući.
Wait a minute.
Čekaj malo.
God's house?
Božoj kući?
You mean God in God's house?
Znači, ti misliš baš u Božoj kući.
There are vessels of dishonor.
Bit će posude nečasti.
And Paul warns in God's house.
I Pavle upozorava u Božoj kući.
Are vessels of honor.
Bit će posude časti.
And vessels of dishonor.
I posude nečasti.
You say God.
A čekajte, Bog ti kaže.
What are you doing?
A što ti radiš?
That doesn't sound like a good house.
To se ne čuje kao da je to dobra kuća.
But you don't understand. God,
ali shvatite, Bog
doesn't want robots.
Ne želi imati robote.
God doesn't want people that have no discernment.
Bog ne želi imati ljude koji nemaju raspoznavanja.
In God's house,
u Božoj kući,
he supplies vessels of honor and dishonor.
On ima posude časti i posude nečasti.
And then he tells you.
I onda on kaže tebi.
You.
Ti.
I want you to think.
Ja želim da ti razmišljaš.
I want you to discern.
Ja želim da ti raspoznaješ.
I want you to understand.
Želim da razumiješ.
I don't want you to believe a dogma.
Ne želim da ti vjeruješ nekakvu dogmu.
I don't want you to believe a set of rules.
Ne želim da vjeruješ jedan set pravila.
So that you and I could grow spiritually from faith to faith.
Tako da ti i ja možemo rasti duhovno iz vere u veru.
So that you and I could go from the lion eagle to the man, from the lion to the ox, ox to the man, man to the eagle.
Tako da ti i ja možemo rasti od, znači, od lava do vola, od vola do čovjeka, od čovjeka do orla.
That God's going to supply vessels of honor and dishonor.
Znači, da bi Bog imao posude časti i nečasti.
But remember,
ali zapamtite,
and here I want to read something for you.
Želim vam nešto pročitati.
That one of the laws of God,
da je jedan od Božjih zakona,
is that if God supplies an obligation,
ako Bog, dakle, zatraži nekakvu obligaciju, znači da nekoga vezuje za nešto,
then he has to supply a remedy.
onda on mora i zagotoviti, pribaviti ono što je potrebno da se to zadovolji.
If you want to write something down, write this down.
Ako želite nešto zapisati, onda zapišite ovo.
If God demands an obligation.
Ako Bog zahtjeva od nas nekakav, ima zahtjev prema nama.
Then God has to supply the remedy to meet the obligation.
Onda Bog mora dati na raspolaganje ono što je potrebno da mi možemo ispuniti taj zahtjev. Amen.
Now, if God says,
ako Bog kaže,
that there's going to be a bride,
da će postajati nevesta,
and she's going to be pure,
i da će ona biti čista,
spotless,
bez mane,
perfect,
da će biti potpuna,
listen carefully,
pažljivo slušajte,
what that means is God has to supply the remedy to meet the obligation.
Onda, ako to znači to, onda Bog mora dati ono što je potrebno da bi se to moglo ispuniti.
Amen. It's not up to you,
nije o vama,
to work your way to meet God's demand.
Da, ajmo reći, odradite taj dio da bi susreli Božje zahtjeve.
Amen.
Amen.
It's up to God,
nego je to od Boga,
to supply the channel,
da zagotovi taj kanal,
and the drive,
znači i taj poriv, motivaciju
in you,
u tebi,
to meet his obligation.
Da ti ispuniš njegove zahtjeve.
It wasn't me,
nisam bio ja taj
running after God,
koji sam trčao za Bogom.
It was God,
nego je bio Bog
running after me,
koji je trčao za mnom.
If God says,
ako Bog kaže,
that there's going to have to be faith,
da će trebati postojati vera,
for a translation,
za prenos na drugu stranu,
that means God,
onda znači da Bog
has to go to work,
mora odraditi
ono, and bankrupt heaven,
i znači isprazniti cijelo nebo,
if so that there will be a way,
zato da će postojati put
for us to be translated,
da mi možemo biti prenešeni tamo.
If God says,
ako Bog kaže,
I want a pure bride,
ja želim imati čistu nevestu,
I want a son and daughter of God,
ja želim imati sina i kćer Božju,
that means God has to supply a way,
onda Bog mora osigurati put
for you,
za tebe,
and you,
i za tebe,
and you,
i za tebe,
to recognize,
da prepoznamo,
I'm a son of God,
ja sam Božji sin.
And it's not a matter of me,
i ne radi se o meni,
I want to pray longer,
ja želim još duže moliti se,
I want to read my Bible,
ja
more,
želim još više čitati
Bibliju, I want
Bibliju,
to go to church more,
ja želim još više odlaziti u crkvu.
Every time you do that,
svaki put kad ti to napraviš,
you take energy away from what God has supplied,
ti uzimaš energiju od onoga što je priskrbio Bog.
But on the other side,
ali na drugoj strani,
if God can give you,
ako ti Bog može
the
dati
revelation,
otkrivenje,
that the cloud holds,
onoga što drži oblak,
that the cloud came for you,
znači da je oblak došao za tebe,
and you are a son,
i da ti jesi sin,
and you are a daughter,
ti jesi kćer,
now,
sada,
you want to read your Bible more,
ti želiš još više čitati Bibliju.
Amen.
Amen.
And you want to pray more.
I tada ti želiš
and
još više moliti.
I
želiš hodati čistim životom.
Because the cloud,
jer oblak,
holds the revelation,
drži u sebi otkrivenje
of where you belong,
onoga gdje ti pripadaš, da ti da veru,
to overcome the care to live, overcome the cares of the world.
Da pobediš, znači brige ovoga svijeta.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Oh, listen to the words of the prophet.
Slušajte sad reči proroka.
Did you ever notice a great thing?
Da li ste ikada zapazili ovu veliku stvar?
That God had to be made flesh.
Da je Bog morao postati telom.
Because it wouldn't be right,
jer ne bi bilo pravilno ili ispravno,
if somebody else was made flesh,
ako bi netko drugi postao telom,
if God was a man of flesh who sent a different man,
ako bi Bog bio znači čovjek koji bi poslao drugog čovjeka,
then it would be two men,
onda bi to bila dva čovjeka,
but that wouldn't be right,
ali to ne bi bilo ispravno.
See, because God couldn't send somebody else.
Vidite, jer Bog nije mogao poslati nekog drugog.
And meet his own obligation.
I onda ispuniti svoje vlastite zahtjeve.
Listen to this.
Slušajte ovo.
This is what makes me so happy.
Ono što me tako obrađuje.
If God pronounced a penalty,
ako je Bog izrekao kaznu,
then he had to take it himself.
Onda je mora sam preuzeti.
In order to do that,
i da bi on to mogao napraviti,
he had to make himself a body,
on je morao sebe napraviti tijelom,
which was created in the Son Jesus Christ,
koje je bilo kreirano u Sinu Isusu Kristu,
and then God dwelt in this,
i onda je Bog prebivao u tome,
for suffering,
da bi trpeo,
and made himself lower than the angels,
i napravio sebe nižim od anđela,
to take on the sin,
da bi preuzeo greh,
and the sicknesses,
i bolesti.
If God pronounces a penalty,
znači ako Bog izreče kaznu,
listen, he has to supply the remedy,
on mora priskrbiti ono što će zadovoljiti tu
to
kaznu,
supply the penalty,
znači da će zadovoljiti
to
tu kaznu, da će ispuniti, da bi mogao biti pravedan.
Amen. So now, if Paul had found a revelation that the cloud held,
znači ako je Pavle našao to otkrivenje koje je bilo u oblaku,
and now he could open a higher level of revelation to overcome,
i da bi sada mogao otvoriti neki viši nivo otkrivenja sa kojim možemo pobediti.
For that first church age,
znači to znači za tu prvu crkvenu dobu.
So then through all the church ages,
i onda kroz sve ostale crkvene dobe,
in the end time,
u zadnje vrijeme,
the scriptures will be fulfilled again,
pismo će ponovo biti ispunjeno.
That means God would have to supply something,
znači da će i tad Bog morat zagotoviti, dat nešto,
to witness to you and I,
da svedoči tebi i meni,
that his penalty has been met,
da je njegova kazna bila ispunjena, zadovoljena.
I don't know if I'm getting this right.
Ne znam da li to pravilno.
But let me back up just a little bit.
Vratimo se još malo nazad.
The Bible says,
Biblija kaže,
that by faith Enoch offered,
da je po veri Enoch ponudio.
Here, let's read that Revelation Hebrews 11.
Hebrejima 11.
I'm so sorry if this is going to be too long.
Ja se ispričavam ako će to biti predugo.
Read verse 4.
Četvrti stih, znači Hebrejima 11:4. Vjerom je Abel prinio Bogu bolju žrtvu negoli Kain, po kojoj je primio svjedočanstvo da je pravedan. Bog je posvjedočio nad njegovim darovima, po njoj i sada, premda je mrtav, govori. I peti stih, verom Henok bijaše prenesen da ne vidi smrt, i nije ga se našlo, jer ga je prenio Bog. No prije svoga prijenosa, primio je svjedočanstvo da je ugodio Bogu.
And without faith it is impossible to please him.
A bez vjere nemoguće je njemu ugoditi.
For he that comes to God must believe first that he is.
Jer onaj tko pristupa Bogu mora vjerovati prvo da
and
on jest i da nagrađuje
of them that diligently seek him.
One koji ga revno traže.
Now let me bring it like this.
Ajmo reći ovako.
That God he always testifies to an accepted gift that'll meet the requirement.
Znači, Bog uvek svedoči primljenom daru koje je prihvaćen.
Okay, now, Abel offered a sacrifice that was acceptable.
Dakle, Abel je prinio žrtvu koja je bila prihvaćena.
He did it by faith.
Prihvatljiva, i on je to napravio verom.
Which is a revelation.
Koja je otkrivenje.
All right, now. But then God testified to Abel that the requirements were met.
Ali onda je Bog posvjedočio Abelu da je njegov zahtjev bio ispunjen.
Okay, so what I'm saying is God has to testify to you.
Ono što kažem je to, Bog mora posvedočiti tebi
in some way,
na neki način,
which will be a scriptural way,
koji će biti naravno po pismu,
that your faith is accepted,
da je tvoja vera prihvaćena,
for you to be justified,
da ti možeš biti opravdan.
Because God doesn't want nervous sons and daughters always striving. Amen.
Jer Bog ne želi stalno neke nervozne kćeri i sinove koji se stalno nešto bore.
Amen.
Amen.
He wants you to relax.
On želi da se vi opustite.
Enjoy.
I da uživate.
Experience.
Da imate iskustva.
Rejoice.
Da se veselite.
Raise your heart.
Da podignete svoje
Raise
srce,
your hands.
Da se razveselite, dignete ruke.
He has to testify to you.
I zbog toga on mora vama svedočiti
that you have met his requirement.
Da ste vi ispunili njegove zahtjeve.
All right.
Amen.
Now you need to catch that part.
I sad pazite, taj dio morate uhvatiti.
Now what?
Vidite sad.
Adam lived 969 years.
Adam je živio 969 godina.
Do you know that Enoch, da li, for 65 years, there was no indication that he served God.
Znači, znate li to da za Enoha prvih 65 godina ne znamo da li on služio Bogu?
But then Enoch had a child.
Ali onda je imao Enoh dete.
And the child was a sign. The child had a sign in the child.
I dakle to dete u sebi imalo znak,
because Methuselah means the deluge will come at my death.
Jer Metušalah znači da će doći potop kad ja umrem.
All right, now watch, this is so good.
Pazite, to je tako dobro.
So Methuselah,
dakle Metušalah,
he has a sign written in his life.
On je imao znak upisan u svoj vlastiti život.
That when he dies,
da kada on umre,
the Lord will, the destruction will come.
Doći će potop.
He lives
on živi,
969 years.
Znači 969 godina.
He has a son Lemach.
On ima sina, Lemoha.
But the part Lemacha. That's interesting is,
al taj zanimljivi dio tu
je, do you know that Adam,
znate li da Adam
could talk to Enoch for 308 years.
Da je mogao Adam govoriti direktno Enohu 308 godina.
And that he also talked with Methuselah for 243 years.
Da je isto tako mogao govoriti Metušalahu 243 godine. Amen.
Imagine.
I pa
zamislite. Here's Adam.
Tu je Adam.
And here's Eve.
I tu je Eva.
And they have lived through the Garden of Eden.
I oni su živeli u Edenskom vrtu.
They saw their sons' sacrifices.
Oni su vidjeli žrtve svojih sinova.
They know serpent seed.
Oni znaju zmičevo seme.
And the generations are getting worse and worse.
I generacije su sve gore i gore i gore i gore, i to je Kainovo seme.
And here's Adam, he's walking on his earth.
I sad tu je Adam, sad on hoda po toj
and
zemlji.
He comes to the coffee shop.
I on dođe u kafanu.
And he meets somebody from Cain's lineage.
I on sretne nekoga iz Kainove linije.
And he says, hey.
I kaže, hey.
Boy, the Garden of Eden was beautiful.
Znači, Edenski vrt bio je divan.
And the other person says, I don't care.
I ova druga osoba kaže, šta mene briga.
And Adam looks.
I Adam gleda.
And the original, the first Adam, right?
Znači, taj originalni, prvi
he's so
Adam,
disappointed.
On je tako razočaran.
So he goes to the lake and he's fishing.
I on ide tamo na jezero i peca ribe.
And he sees somebody on the beach.
I on vidi nekoga na obali.
And he tries to tell them what happened in the Garden of Eden.
I ponovo on se muči da mu kaže šta se, kako je bilo u Edenskom
vrtu. But they're not interested.
Ali oni uopšte nisu zainteresovani. Oni su pogrešno
sebe. And so Adam is feeling lonely.
I tako Adam se osjeća usamljeno.
He's got all of the original seed in him.
On ima to originalno seme u sebi.
Until one day,
dok jednog dana,
he meets Enoch.
On sretne Enoha.
And he says, hey Enoch.
I kaže, hey Enoch.
You should have been there that day.
Ti bi morao biti tamo tog dana.
I never knew what blood was.
Nikad nisam znao šta krv znači.
Till God killed that first lamb.
Dok Bog nije ubio to prvo jagnje.
And I felt so bad.
I ja sam se tako loše osjećao.
And I was running away from God.
I ja sam trčao, bežao sam od Boga.
But then God came running after me.
Ali onda je Bog išao za
mnom. So bad,
i ja sam se tako loše osjećao,
that he took this bloody sheepskin,
da je on uzeo svoje, znači odjeću ovce i omotao oko mene,
and all of a sudden,
i odjednom,
I could stand in God's presence.
Ja sam mogao stajati u Božoj prisutnosti.
Not because of me.
Ne zbog mene.
But because of this blood running down my feet.
Nego zbog ove krvi koja je tekla po mojim nogama. Amen.
And Enoch was drinking his cappuccino.
I Enoch je pio svoj cappuccino.
And they were eating a little baklava.
I oni su jeli baklavu.
And something inside of Enoch.
I nešto unutar Enoha.
Amen. Said, I believe that.
I je reklo, ja to verujem.
I believe
Amen.
That.
Amen. Ja to verujem.
Oh, that sounds good to me.
Tako mi to dobro zvuči.
And then Adam would say.
I onda bi Adam rekao.
And it was so sad.
I to je bilo tako žalostno.
When I came to my wife.
Kada sam došao moje ženi.
And I had this judgment on me.
I ja sam imao tu osudu na meni.
And under the judgment.
I po tom osudom.
Here's my wonderful wife.
Tu je moja dražesna žena.
And I knew she had the serpent seed in her.
I ja sam znao da ona ima zmičevo seme unutar
sebe. Oh, it felt so sad that day.
I tako je bilo žalostno tog dana.
Until all of a sudden.
Dok odjedno.
I had a revelation.
Dobio sam otkrivenje
that I
da ja
am the original son.
Da sam ja originalni sin. Amen.
This
I ovo
is my creation.
Je moja kreacija.
It came from me.
Došlo je iz mene.
And if God respects his original creation,
I ako Bog poštuje svoje originalno
stvarstvo, I am original.
I ja sam original.
Woo!
Amen.
Woo!
Amen.
Woo!
Amen.
If I take my seed,
ako ja uzmem svoje seme,
and put it in that womb,
i stavim je u tu maternicu, u tu ženu,
beside the serpent seed,
i to do samog zmičevog semena,
that God,
onda će Bog,
will save her,
on će spasiti nju,
because of my seed,
zbog mog
in her womb,
u njezinoj utrobi,
amen. And all church,
i cijela crkva,
when I explained it to Eve.
Kada sam ja to objasnio Evi,
because you see at first,
jer vidite, prvo,
Eve was feeling bad.
Eva se loše osjećala.
And she just wanted to hug me.
I ona je željela da me zagrli.
And she wanted to cry on my shoulders.
I ona je željela da plače na mom ramenu.
Because she was emotional.
Jer je bila puna emocija.
But I said, Eve,
a ja sam rekao, Eva,
stop.
Zaustavi se.
Listen.
Slušaj.
Look in my eyes.
Gledaj me u oči. Amen.
And then Adam,
i onda Adam
revealed seven seed redemption.
On otkriva, znači, otkupljenje sedam semena.
And what redemption was all about.
Znači, onoga što otkupljenje stvarno
and then
znači.
As Adam was talking to Eve,
i onda kako je Adam razgovarao s Evom,
that something happened in Eve,
nešto se dogodilo u
and
Evi.
She realized,
i ona je doznala, shvatila.
I want everybody to listen.
Slušajte me sad.
Emotions are not salvation.
Osjećanja nisu spasenja, emocije.
Ha?
Jel tako?
Pentecostal experience. I love everybody.
Znači, pentakostalno iskustvo, oni sve ljube. Oni svi sve ljube.
Is not salvation.
Ali to nije spasenje.
Beautiful music.
Čudesna muzika.
Rock and roll band.
Rock and roll bendovi.
Anointing.
Pomazanje.
Is not salvation.
To nije spasenje.
But salvation,
nego je spasenje,
comes in the seed.
Dolazi u semenu.
And
amen.
The seed is
I
God's word.
Je Božja reč.
And if you accept God's seed,
i ako vi prihvatite
now
Božje
you can
seme,
have salvation.
Sad vi možete imati spasenje.
Amen.
Amen.
See. Hallelujah. And as Adam was telling Enoch the story,
i kako je Adam govorio Enohu tu priču,
something happened in Enoch.
Nešto se dogodilo u Enohu.
And Enoch had a sign child with the prophecy written in his name.
I Enoh je imao toga sina u kojem, u čijem imenu je bila zapisano proročanstvo.
And Enoch,
i Enoh
had faith,
je imao veru,
to be translated,
da bude prenešen,
because he had the faith of the original Adam.
Jer je imao veru originalnog Adama.
Oh!
Amen.
Do you know Brother Branham says,
znate da brat Branham
that
kaže,
was Abraham's faith,
da je bila Abrahamova vera
in the promise,
u obećanju,
that created that seed in Sarah.
Koje je kreiralo to seme u Sari. Amen.
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 It's God, it's Jesus Christ, our husband's faith.
Znači, to je
Amen.
Vera Isusa Krista, našeg ženika,
in the promise,
u obećanje,
us believing His faith,
znači vjerujući njegovoj
in
veri,
the promise,
u obećanje,
is creating,
to je on
a seed in me,
seme u meni,
and now His salvation becomes my salvation.
I sada njegovo spasenje postane moje spasenje.
you say, brother Eugene, why are you saying that?
I ti kažeš, pa brate Eugene, zašto ti to kažeš?
Stay in honor.
Ostanite u časti.
In God's house are many vessels, some dishonor, some with honor.
U Božoj kući ima puno posuda, neke su za
čast,
neke za nečast.
I'm sorry. But endure hardness.
Ali izdržite.
As a good soldier.
Kao dobri vojnici.
Stay in honor.
Ostanite u časti.
Amen.
Amen. And here Noah was born.
I sad je bio rođen Noah.
Enoch left.
Enoch je napustio.
He left three signs.
On je napustio iza sebe tri znaka.
One a prophecy.
Jedno je bilo proročanstvo.
One a pyramid.
A pyramid. Jedna piramida.
Enoch left a pyramid.
Znači Enoh je napustio
to
piramidu.
To give Noah faith.
Da bi Noi dao veru.
Oh, this is so good.
To je tako dobro.
And he left a prophecy.
I on je ostavio proročanstvo.
And now Noah is walking.
I sada Noah ide.
And he's believing Enoch's message, which is Methuselah.
I on veruje Enohovu poruku koja je Metušalah.
Enoch is gone.
Enoch je otišao.
But Methuselah is here.
Ali Metušalah je još uvijek tu.
And Methuselah is the message to Enoch with the evidence written in his name.
I Metušalah je poruka Enohu koji ima, znači, svedočanstvo upisano u svoje vlastito ime.
And now he's fellowshipping with the prophet's message.
I znači on sad je u zajedništvu sa proročkom porukom.
And is building faith in him.
I to izgrađuje veru u njemu.
And he's walking along one day.
I on tako ide jednog dana.
And as he's fellowshipping with Methuselah.
I tako kao i zajedništvu sa Metušalahom.
He's looking at Enoch.
On gleda na Enoha.
And when he recognizes.
Kada on prepozna.
Oh, friends.
Prijatelj.
The prophet is taken.
Prorok je otišao.
The message is still here.
Poruka je još uvijek tu.
The witness is at hand.
Znači, svedočanstvo, odnosno svedok je tu.
We're at the edge of a deluge.
Mi smo na kraju, znači, na samom rubu tog potopa.
And Methuselah's message,
i Metušalahovo poruka
inspires the faith of Enoch.
Inspirira Enohovu veru.
And Enoch is going to start building an ark.
I Enoh počinje graditi
by faith.
Znači,
Noah, I'm sorry. Got it.
Noah počinje graditi arku, znači tu barku.
God testifying to his gift.
Znači, Bog svedoči svom daru.
I don't know where to quit.
Ne znam gdje stati.
Genesis chapter 38.
Postanka, knjiga Postanka, prva Mojsijeva, dakle 308.
You know, if it wasn't for the prophet's message, we'd have nothing to preach.
Znate, ako ne bi bilo poruke proroka, mi ne bi imali šta propovedati.
That's why Paul told us to be stewards of the mystery.
Znači, zbog toga je Pavle rekao da mi budemo upravitelji tajne.
I want you to notice something.
Želim da vidite nešto.
I want you to turn to Genesis chapter 37.
Okrenimo u Postanak 37.
This story is about Joseph, who's the type of Christ.
Znači, ova priča govori o Josipu koji je tip Krista.
And in Genesis 37, Joseph is now 17 years old.
I u Postanku 37 Josip ima 17 godina.
17 is a number of redemption.
17 je znači broj otkupljenja.
He goes through the rejection.
On znači ide kroz odbacivanje, odbacili su ga njegova braća.
In other words, Jesus Christ came to Israel and they rejected him.
I s drugim riječima Isus Krist je došao u Izrael i oni su ga odbacili.
Joseph gets thrown into his Calvary.
I Isus je Josip je bio bačen u svoju Golgotu.
Right? He gets thrown in the pit. That's his Calvary.
On je bio bačen u tu jamu, to je njegova Golgota.
So now Joseph is thrown into his Calvary.
I tako je Josip bačen u svoju Golgotu.
And now Joseph is taken up into the land of the Gentiles.
I sada je on uzet i ponešen u pagansku zemlju.
And now in chapter 38.
I sada u 38. glavi.
And to save time,
da malo prištedimo na vremenu.
The scene changes.
Sada se cela scena menja.
Let's say brother Uroš is Joseph.
Recimo da je brat Uroš Josip.
The scene changes from the Joseph perspective to a Tamar perspective, a Gentile woman.
Znači, sada se scena menja iz Josipove perspektive pogleda u Tamarin pogled.
But once the Gentile woman is done dealing with in Genesis 38,
i znači ona je bila paganka i na kraju kada znači prestanemo, ajmo reći, raditi sa tom pagankinjom, žena,
then the story continues again to Joseph.
Onda se ta priča ponovo nastavlja sa Josipom.
So it's Joseph,
znači Josip,
Tamar,
Tamara,
Joseph,
i Josip.
Jewish,
Jevreji,
Gentile,
pagani,
back to the original story.
I ponovo se vraćamo u originalnu
priču. So you'll
priču.
Find that Paul says, make sure you're stewards of the mystery.
I zbog toga Pavle kaže, budite sigurni da ste stvarno upravitelji tajne.
Now I want you to watch back sad, over here in Genesis 38.
I sad želim da vidite tu u Postanku 308.
That the seed of Judah was getting very scarce.
Da je Judinog semena bilo jako malo.
And there's a Gentile woman that wanted redemption, which was in the Jewish line.
I da je postajala tu paganka žena koja je tražila otkupljenje koje je bilo samo u Judinoj liniji.
I want you to notice.
I želim da vidite to.
She knew that redemption laid in that seed line.
Ona je znala da otkupljenje stoji u toj liniji semena.
So what could this woman do?
I šta je sad ova žena mogla napraviti?
To get part of that redemption.
Da postane dio tog otkupljenja.
And so there's a mystery written in every one of these words.
I znate, tajna je zapisana u svakoj od ovih reči.
The word adulamite actually means justice of the people.
Znači, reč adulamite znači pravednost ljudi.
And the word shua means wealth.
I onda reč shua znači bogatstvo.
And the word heir, the second boy, means arouse, to awaken to destruction.
I znači treći ime trećeg dečaka, er, znači podigni se, odnosno osvesti se, uništenja. Znači biti snažan.
And cherub means a partition, to be proven, it has to do with proving a lie.
I znači čezib znači biti dokazan, nešto što je dokazano.
And the word tamar itself means a palm tree.
I tamara, ta sama reč znači palmino drvo, palma.
Now I want you to just for the sake of time, here's a woman.
I da uštedimo na vremenu, sad vidimo, tu je jedna žena.
That's given the first son,
kojoj je dan prvi sin.
And there isn't there's no reproduction.
I nema reprodukcije iz toga.
And then
he comes to the
ox age.
I onda dolazi u vreme vola.
And there's not a fullness of production.
I tu nema isto tako produkcije.
Then he comes to the man age.
I onda dolazi u čovječe doba.
Through the seven church ages.
Kroz svih sedam crkvenih doba.
Here's a woman.
Tu je ta žena.
That literally goes through the seven church ages.
Koja bukvalno prolazi kroz sedam crkvenih
all
doba.
The church ages.
I kroz sve crkvene dobe.
She still can't get into that resurrected glorified body with the seed in her.
Ona još uvek ne može ući u to ustalo, znači uskrsnuto, oslavljeno telo, znači da reproducira.
And then finally Judah says, put her away to womanhood, and that was a reproach.
I onda konačno kaže Juda, ma ostavite u njenom, ajmo reći, ženskom životu.
Because the church that didn't bear seed was a reproach.
I to je sramota, jer crkva koja nije mogla primiti seme, to je bila sramota za nju.
And then verse 12 is a very special connotation.
I onda u tom 12. stihu imamo jedno nešto vrlo značajno.
And the Bible says, in the process of time.
I onda Biblija kaže s vremenom.
And if you'll notice, that corresponds to Revelations 10, and time shall be no more.
I pazite, to je u suglasnosti sa Otkrivenjem 10, gdje kaže i vremena više neće biti.
In other words, there's been a delay.
Znači tu je neki,
there's been a delay.
Znači nešto zastalo vremena i zastalo je vreme
delay.
I zastalo je vreme.
But finally God says,
i na kraju Bog kaže,
I'm taken over.
Ja sad preuzimam.
Time shall be no more.
Vremena više neće biti.
Redemption is going to finish.
I sad će se otkupljenje
završiti. Amen. Wonderful. So now she comes to that time when God has decreed.
I sada ona dolazi u to vreme kada je Bog odredio
that now redemption will go on.
Da će sada otkupljenje ići korak dalje.
Now remember, Tamar,
i sada Tamara,
in her condition,
u njezinom stanju.
She bears herself in a reproach. She dresses like an harlot.
Znači, ona u biti na sebe stavlja sramotu. Ona se oblači kao prostitutka.
And she had to go down to a level of low, low, low humility.
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 I know. I sada ona se morala spustiti u ono najniže stanje, znači ponizenja.
But when she's done,
ali kad je došla do toga,
now,
sada,
like she's not satisfied with all the other seeds,
znači ona nije zadovoljna sa svim ostalim semenima,
now she wants to go back to the original seed.
Ona želi se vratiti kao originalnom semenu.
And she managed to attain the original seed.
I ona uspije pridobiti to originalno seme.
But she knows.
Ali ona zna.
She's risking a reproach.
Da ona riskira da bude osramoćena.
She's going to be looked on as a low, low, low person in society.
Na nju će se gledati kao na najnižu osobu u društvu.
Hey.
Amen.
I remember when the message came my way.
Ja se sjećam kada je poruka došla mojim putem.
The message,
poruka,
in our town,
u našem gradu,
it came to people that were just poor.
Došla je ljudima koji su
rough people.
Bili jednostavno siromašni ljudi.
My mom and dad,
moje otac i mama,
were wealthy farmers.
Oni su bili bogati farmeri.
And when I started listening to the message,
i kad sam ja počeo slušati poruku,
I had to bear the reproach.
Ja sam morao nositi
sramotu. That God would never move in those kind of people. It would be in our church.
Znači, koje Bog nije, znači u toj crkvi koje Bog nije imao.
But for me,
ali za mene,
the revelation of the word,
otkrivenje reči,
was more important than the reproach they could put on me.
Je bila puno značajnija nego sramota koja je dolazila s tim.
You understand?
Da li razumijete?
That's why,
zbog toga,
sometimes,
nekada,
to get one pearl,
da dobijete jedan biser,
you gotta buy the whole piece of land.
Vi morate kupiti celi parče zemlje.
But in that land,
ali u toj zemlji,
are weeds.
Su i je i kukolj.
And vessels of dishonor.
I posude nečasti.
But it doesn't matter.
Ali to nije važno.
I want the pearl.
Ja želim taj biser.
I want the pearl.
Ja želim taj biser.
I want the pearl.
Ja želim taj biser.
I'll buy all the land.
Ja ću kupiti celu zemlju.
All the good.
Sve ono.
All the bad.
Sve dobro i sve slabo.
All the dishonor.
I sve nečasno.
All the shame.
I svu sramotu.
All the reproach.
I svu da sramotu.
But I want the pearl.
Ali želim taj biser. Amen.
And she knew.
I ona je znala.
She was going to bear a reproach to get the seed.
Da će nositi sramotu da bi mogla primiti to seme.
And she knew.
I ona je znala.
That judgment was coming.
Da dolazi sud.
So she had to get evidence.
To, dakle, ona je mogla pridobiti dokaz.
She needed something.
Ona, njoj je trebalo nešto.
That would testify to the gift.
Što bi svedočilo tom daru.
So that if she could present her token,
dakle, kad bi ona mogla pokazati svoj znak,
it would testify of her honor,
svedočiti o njezinoj časti,
though it looked dishonorable,
iako je to izgledalo nečasno.
You see what I mean?
Da li vidite što
stay in honor.
Ostanite u
stay
časti.
In honor.
Ostanite u časti.
You're going to need something.
Vi ćete trebati
in
nešto
the day of judgment,
na danu suda,
that God will testify to like he did Abel.
Znači, da će Bog posvjedočiti dočiti kao što je to on napravio Abelu,
that you're going to stay in honor, that you're honorable,
da ćete ostati u časti, znači da ste
so
časni.
She said, Judah,
i on je rekla, Judah,
give me your signet,
daj mi tvoj pečat,
give me your staff,
da, tvoju palicu,
give me your bracelet,
daj mi tvoju narukavicu.
And that word signet,
i znači ta reč pečat,
actually is the Old Testament word for seal,
je dakle starozavetna reč za pečat.
That means it's the stamp of final authority.
Znači to je taj pečat svevišnje, ajmo reći, autoriteta.
It is the seal,
znači to je pečat
that shrouds the authority of that document,
koje potvrđuje sa autoritetom taj dokument.
Praise the Lord.
Slava Bogu.
This day and age,
u ovom dobu,
we've got the seals,
mi imamo pečate,
that were the final authority,
koje su konačni autoritet,
undisputable,
kojeg ne možemo poreći,
as we're in the edge of judgment,
jer smo na samom kraju pred sud.
But we're going to need something.
Ali nama će biti potrebno nešto.
From the original.
Od originala.
Not the church world.
Ne iz crkvenog sveta.
It's got to come from the original.
Nego mora doći od originala.
to testify to your honor.
Tvoju čast.
Because judgment is coming.
Jer sud dolazi.
This message didn't come from the church world.
Ova poruka nije došla iz crkvenog sveta. Amen.
This message came from heaven.
Ova poruka je došla iz neba.
This message is not a female message.
Ova poruka nije ženska poruka.
This is not a church message.
Ova nije poruka crkve.
This is not an improvement on Wesley.
Ovo nije neko poboljšanje Wesleya.
Or an improvement
ili poboljšanje
on Methodist.
Metodista.
Or an improvement on Pentecost.
Ili poboljšanje Pentecosta.
This message is an original creation.
Je originalno stvorenje
that you need
koje tebi potrebno
to testify
da svedoči
to God
Bogu
that you are staying in honor.
Da si ti ostao i stojiš u časti.
I was told one time when I came to the message.
Kad sam došao u poruku, jedno mi je bilo rečeno.
Brother Eugene.
Brate Eugene.
Look.
Gledaj.
Luther had a revelation of justification.
Luther je imao otkrivenje opravdanja.
The Pentecost had a revelation of restored gifts.
Pentakost je imao otkrivenje obnovljenih darova.
And just then the Lord just so inspired me.
I baš u tom trenutku Bog me je tako inspirirao.
I said, yeah.
Rekao sam da.
But
ali
this is not a modified version of a female message.
Ovo nije nekako modificirana, malo dopunjena verzija ženske poruke.
This message,
ova poruka,
referred back to the original seed.
Se referira, odnosno gleda natrag na originalno seme.
For an original purpose,
za originalni smisao,
from an original throne,
od originalnog prestola,
for original children,
od originalnog, ajmo reći, ramen.
I said to that man, I said,
i rekao sam tom čovjeku,
but wait a minute,
ali čekaj malo.
If you're pardoned,
ako si ti opravdan,
are you restored?
Da li si ti i vraćen u originalno stanje, restauriran?
He said yes.
On je rekao da.
I said no, you're not.
Rekao sam ne, nisi.
No.
Ne, nisi.
That's not what this message came for.
To nije
this
ono za čega je poruka došla. Ova poruka
didn't come to pardon you.
Nije došla da te opravda.
It came to bring you to full restoration.
Nego da te vrati u punu restauraciju, znači u ono originalno stanje.
Look.
Gledaj.
Let's say brother Uroš.
Recimo da je brat Uroš.
Steals money.
Da on ukrade novac.
Okay?
Okay?
Now. And he steals my money.
I on ukrade moj novac.
All right? So now I can pardon him.
Ja mu mogu oprostiti.
But a pardon only takes away the penalty.
Ali taj to da mu ja oprostim samo oduzme kaznu.
I can forgive him.
Ja mu mogu oprostiti.
And forgiveness takes away the act.
I to u biti oduzima to djelo, da mu oprostim to oduzima djelo.
But it still doesn't restore brother Uroš back to the condition before he stole the money.
Ali još uvijek to ne dovodi brata Uroša natrag u onu poziciju koju je držao prije nego što je ukrao taj novac.
Do you understand?
Da li razumijete to?
Huh? It's wonderful to be forgiven.
Znači, odlično je da ti je oprošteno.
I love it.
I mean, ja to volim.
It's wonderful.
Odlično je
for the judge to say you are pardoned.
Da sudac kaže tebi je oprošteno.
But when you walk into the courtroom,
ali kad ti izađeš iz tog sudskog ureda,
you're still a criminal.
Ti si još uvijek kriminalac.
Because the pardon only takes away the judgment.
Jer taj oproštaj, odnosno to da ti je oprošteno, samo oduzima kaznu, sud.
Amen.
Amen.
But when God sent a prophet,
ali kad je Bog poslao proroka,
and the revelation in the cloud restored the revelation of faith,
I otkrivenje u oblaku restaurirao je otkrivenje vere.
And open up an original seed.
I otvorilo je originalno seme.
Now,
sada,
you're not just pardoned.
Tebi nije samo oprošteno.
You're not just forgiven.
Tebi nije samo otpušteno, znači otpušteno.
Because that just takes away the penalty of the crime you committed.
Jer to u biti tebi samo oduzima kaznu koju bi trebao podnositi za svoj greh.
Because you can take away the penalty and still leave a man a sinner.
Znate, vi možete nekome oduzeti kaznu, ali on još uvijek živi kao grešnik.
Everybody understand, right?
Da li svi razumemo?
You could take away the penalty.
Vi možete oduzeti kaznu.
Of the sin.
Znači njegovog greha.
But the man still walks out a sinner.
Ali čovjek još uvijek izađe odatle kao grešnik.
But when the prophet came.
Ali kada je prorok došao.
And he opened up the mystery.
I on je otvorio tajnu.
And something deep inside of you.
I nešto duboko u tebi.
Started calling to the mystery.
Je počelo dozivati tu tajnu.
That's not just forgiving the crime.
To ne znači samo da ti je otpušten taj to kriminalno zlo djelo.
But he's pulling you back up.
Nego te on i povuče
to an original position.
Natrag u svoju originalnu poziciju.
Now,
i sada,
you're a full son.
Ti si punovrijedni sin.
And you're a full daughter.
I punovredna kćer.
With full rights.
Sa punim pravima.
Even though your crime has been forgiven.
Iako je tvoje kriminalno djelo bilo oprošteno.
Big difference.
I to je velika razlika.
Big difference.
Velika razlika.
By faith.
Verom.
Enoch.
Enoch.
By faith.
Verom.
Abraham.
Abraham.
By faith.
Verom.
Okay, look.
Gledajte.
There's two kinds of faith.
Postoje dve vrste vere.
There's a kind of faith that we exercise.
Ima jedna, postoji vera koju mi upotrebljavamo.
We build faith.
Znači, gde gradimo veru.
Faith comes by hearing.
Vera dolazi slušanjem.
And hearing of the word of God.
Slušanjem reči Božje.
Sometimes our faith is up.
I ponekad naša vera je gore.
And sometimes our faith is down.
I nekad ponekad naša vera je dole.
Sometimes our faith is up.
Ponovo jednom je gore.
Sometimes our faith is down.
Ponekad jednom je dole.
But that's not the faith, the kind of faith that Luke talks about in 18:8. Turn with me there. This is just.
Ali to nije ta vera o kojoj govori Luka u 18:8.
Just for a minute, and what time is
samo
it?
Za trenutak.
12 o'clock. Okay. Oh, it's 12 o'clock. We got an hour. Matthew, Mark, Luke. Verse 29, Luke 18.
Luka 18, 29.
I'm sorry, Luke 17, I'm sorry.
Pardon, Luke Luka 17.
I want you to notice that this whole thing is coming down to the spot where there's going to be some very vital questions asked.
Želim da obratite pažnju da dolazimo do dana gdje će biti pitana vrlo vitalna pitanja.
And there's a question asked.
I tu je pitano pitanje.
In verse 7, Luke 17:30.
U 17:30.
Thus,
Luka 17:30.
Thus shall it be in the day when the Son of Man is revealed.
Isto će tako biti u dan kada se Sin čovječji objavi.
Now we could go to Ezekiel 3 and 8, Deuteronomy 18, but I want to get to something else.
Mi možemo ići u Ezekiel 3 u Deuteronomy 8, ali želim nešto drugo.
So it shows the condition of the world when the Son of Man is revealed, all right?
Znači kako će biti stanje sveta kada Sin čovječji bude otkriven.
But then he comes to verse 6 in chapter 18.
I onda dolazi do šestog stiha u 18. glavi.
And the Lord said, hear what the unjust saith.
I reče Gospodin, čujte što govori nepravedni sudac.
Shall not God avenge his own elect?
Neće li onda Bog obraniti svoje izabranike?
Now,
sada,
he's making reference to the election of sons of God.
On govori o izboru sinova Božjih.
And then in verse 8 it says,
I onda u 8. stihu kaže,
I tell you that he will avenge them speedily.
Kažem vam da će ih žurno obraniti.
Nevertheless,
no hoće,
when the Son of Man cometh.
Li Sin čovječji kada dođe.
Is that your day?
Da li je to tvoj dan? Amen.
He's asking a question.
On pita pitanje.
Jesus is asking a question.
Isus pita pitanje.
2000 years ago.
2000 godina unazad.
Before the church ages.
Prije crkvenih doba.
I have a question for you.
Ja imam jedno pitanje za vas.
When the Son of Man comes.
Kada Sin čovječi dođe.
I have a question.
Imam pitanje.
Will I find faith on this earth?
Da li ću ja naći vjeru na ovoj zemlji?
Now watch.
Pazite.
This word faith,
ova reč vera,
does not mean the faith that we exercise.
Ne znači onu veru koju mi svakodnevno treniramo.
And try to believe.
I pokušamo vjerovati.
And memorize scripture verses.
I zapamtiti stihove biblijske.
And go to church. That's
I
not what this faith means.
U crkvu. Ne, to ne znači ta reč vera. Tu.
This word faith is not a personal faith.
Ta reč vera tu nije osobna vera,
but this word faith specifically,
nego ova reč
means,
vera specifično posebno ima značenje,
do you believe the whole body of revealed truth?
Da li ti vjeruješ u celokupno telo otkrivene reči?
Now watch.
I sad gledajte.
You live in the same world I do.
Vi živite u istom svijetu.
You breathe the same air I do.
Vi dišete isti zrak koji ja dišem.
There's times I feel strong.
Postoje dani kada se ja osjećam snažni.
There's times I feel weak.
I postoje dani kada se ja osjećam slabim.
There's times I'm so ashamed of myself.
Postoje dani kada sam ja tako se stidim samoga sebe.
Okay.
Jel tako?
Amen.
Jel tako?
But you know something?
Ali znate nešto?
I believe.
Ja vjerujem.
The revealed truth for this day.
Otkrivenu istinu ovoga dana. Amen. Amen.
And then he goes on Colossians 1.
I onda ide dalje u Kolosanima 1.
And he says, now if you continue in the faith.
I kaže, ako vi idete dalje u vjeri.
Rooted.
I ukorinjeni ste.
Settled. Settled.
Da, u stabilizirani, ajmo reći.
Grounded.
Dakle, ukorenjeni, stavite.
That does not refer to the faith when you're up and down.
To
and up and down.
To dakle nije onda, ne govori o toj veri gdje vi idete gore i dole, i gore i dole.
That word faith,
ta reč vera,
means
znači
the faith
vera
in the revealed word of truth for the Son of Man's ministry.
U otkrivenu reč istine službe Sina čovječe.
And no matter if I'm up
i bez obzira
or
sam
down,
gore ili dole,
I feel good about myself,
da li se ja osjećam
or I feel bad about myself,
ili ja gledam na sebe,
I believe,
ja vjerujem,
in the revealed truth,
u otkrivenu istinu,
for the Son of Man ministry day.
Za službu, za dan službe Sina čovječe.
And when Tamar,
i kada je Tamara,
realized,
shvatila,
she was going to have to bear a reproach,
da će morati nositi tu sramotu na sebi,
she's going to have to find something,
da će morat naći nešto,
that's honorable,
što je časno,
from Judah.
Od Jude,
she wants to stay in honor,
ona je željela ostati u časti,
in the eyes of Judah,
u Judinim očima,
but in the eyes of the world,
ali u očima sveta,
she looks dishonorable,
ona izgleda nečasno.
Amen.
Jel tako?
So she's going to need something,
dakle on njoj će biti potrebno nešto,
that will be evidence to testify,
što će biti dokaz, što će svedočiti,
that she was in honor,
da je ona časna,
that Judah can respond to,
znači da ima čast na koju može odgovoriti Juda.
And when God himself,
i kada Bog sam,
came in the cloud in 63.
Kada je on došao u oblaku 63. godine.
He gave me,
on je dao meni,
what I needed,
ono što je meni
to testify,
da mi svedoči,
of my honor,
mojoj časti,
in his eyes,
u njegovim očima,
but,
ali,
it's a reproach,
ali to je sramota,
and a dishonor,
i o nečašćenje,
to the world,
ovome svetu.
But I'll tell you something,
ali reći ću vam
on
nešto,
the day of judgment,
na dan suda,
when judgment comes,
kada će doći sud,
pevac.
I know what I'm gonna hold.
Ja znam što ću držati u rukama.
And I'm gonna take that signet.
I ja ću uzeti taj pečat.
And give it back to God.
Dati ga Bogu.
And God.
I Bog.
Will testify.
Će svedočiti.
Of His gift.
O njegovom daru.
That I stayed in honor.
Da sam ja ostao u časti.
And the day of judgment.
Amen.
Amen.
Suda.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Where would you be?
Gde bi vi bili?
If you were Tamar,
ako bi vi bili Tamara,
and you never got a gift,
i nikad ne bi dobili dar,
from the original seed,
od originalnog semena,
to testify,
da bi svedočio,
of your honor,
tvoje časti.
I have a question for you.
Ja imam sad pitanje za
when
vas.
Judgment comes,
kada dođe sud,
when you come into court,
kada vi dođete na sud,
and the judge is sitting there,
i suda će sedeti
and looking
tamo,
down on you,
i gledati dole na tebe,
and you have witnesses,
i ti ima svedoke tu,
and they're against you,
i oni su protiv tebe,
and he's looking down on you,
dole na tebe.
You're going to need something.
Tebi će biti potrebno nešto. Amen.
To prove that you stayed in honor though you look dirty.
Da što će dokazati da si ti ostao u časti pa makar ti izgledao zaprljan.
So you walk up to the judge.
I tako ćeš ti pristupiti sucu.
Say, yeah, judge.
I reći ću da sudac.
I stole.
Ja sam ukrao.
That's true.
To je istina.
Yeah, judge.
Da, suče.
It's true.
Istina je.
I didn't do very well.
Ja nisam se baš najbolje odrezao.
And I feel ashamed of myself.
I stidim se samoga sebe.
But you know what, judge?
Ali znaš šta, suče?
Let me show you something.
Neka ti je, ajde da ti ja nešto pokažem.
And then you pull out a book.
I ti onda uzmeš knjigu.
And it's the same book he has.
I to je ista knjiga koju on ima. Amen.
He's got the same book you got.
On ima istu knjigu koju ti imaš.
And you can tell the judge.
I ti možeš reći sucu.
This comes from the original author.
Ono, ovo dolazi od originalnog autora.
Turn to page so and so.
Otvori na ovoj i ovoj stranici.
Turn to page so and so.
Otvori na ovoj i ovoj stranici.
Romans 8.
Rimljanima 8.
Ephesians 2.
O Efežanima 2.
Revelations 18.
Otkrivanje 18.
And now
i sada,
you've got something.
Ti imaš nešto.
That's honorable.
Što je častno.
Praise the Lord.
Slava Bogu.
You know, you Znate, folks go through it like we do at home, same way.
Vi ljudi prolazite kroz iste stvari kao i mi kući.
I was wondering why.
Ja sam se pitao zašto.
There's always a spiritual mystery behind things.
Jer znate, iza svih stvari su uvijek neke duhovne tajne.
Why is it?
Zbog čega?
That the dishonor has so wanted to destroy the cloud in 63.
Zašto je znači nečast toliko željno željela uništiti znači u 63. istinu o tom oblaku?
It was strange to me.
To mi je bilo tajnovito.
It makes sense.
Nije mi bilo nekako logično.
And because I know there's always a spirit behind things.
Jer znam da je za svakom stvaru postoji neki duh.
And I looked at that thing and I thought that's so strange that they would attack the cloud.
I izgledalo mi tako čudno, rekao sam tako je tako vrlo čudno da su napali taj oblak.
I was reading Question and Answers last night.
Jučer sam bio pitan to pitanje.
They said, Brother Branham,
rekli su, brat Branham,
when Paul met that cloud,
kada je Pavle sreo taj oblak,
in one instance there was a voice and some saw it and some another instance nobody saw it but there was a voice and there was a discrepancy.
Znači, tu je izgleda kao da se stvari ne poklapaju. Na jednom mjestu kaže da su neki vidjeli oblak i nisu čuli glas, na drugom da su čuli glas i nisu vidjeli oblak.
Brother Branham says,
brat Branham kaže,
I don't know.
Ja ne znam.
I put a smile on my face.
Ja sam se počeo smijati.
If the prophet
ako prorok
can say I don't know,
može reći ja ne znam.
Then I can say,
onda ja mogu reći
I don't know.
Ja ne znam. Amen. Amen.
I got to studying how Paul knew that that cloud was the pillar of fire,
studirao
the original
sam,
pillar of fire.
Znači, studirao sam o tome kako je Pavle znao da je to bio originalni oblak.
odnosno ognjeni stup. Peter and Matthew 17 was actually a witness to the cloud and the voice.
Znači Petar i Matej kako su u Mateju 17 svedočili da je to zaista bio taj oblak.
But Paul later on and placed that experience in the scriptures.
Ali Pavle je tek kasnije postavio to iskustvo u okvir pisma.
And I was studying the Old Testament the day of Passover.
I ja sam studirao Stari zavet na dan Pashe.
And here the priest,
i tu je taj svećenik,
before he went into the holiest of holies,
prije nego što je išao u svetinju nad svetinjama,
he had to go in twice.
On je morao ući dva put.
And the first time he had to go in for himself.
Znači najprije morao ući najprije za samoga sebe.
And I was reading where the priest a week before he went and made the offering.
Ja sam čitao kako je taj sveštenik jednu sedmicu prije nego što je trebao dati tu žrtvu.
They would place the lamb in front of him.
Oni su stavili jagnje pred njega.
And they would place the incense.
I onda su te miomirise stavili.
He had to have it in his mind, his dress had to be perfect.
On je morao imati na umu da je njegovo odelo bilo u potpunosti.
They'd make him practice walking. How he walked.
Onda je on trenirao kako mora hodati on.
They actually made him practice to hold his head.
Čak su ga trenirali kako mora držati svoju glavu.
Don't look left, don't look right.
Ne gledaj levo, ne gledaj desno.
Everything had to be perfect.
Sve je moralo biti potpuno.
And he had to practice that.
I on je morao to trenirati.
Get it in his brain.
On je to morao nekako dobiti u svoj mozak.
So that he wouldn't make a mistake.
Da ne bi on napravio greške.
Because remember, the first time the priest went in, he came to be accepted, to see if he was going to be accepted.
Prvi put kada je sveštenik ušao, on je trebao time vidjeti da li je on sam bio prihvaćen.
And so there was roughly 4,000 people all involved in this ceremony.
I nekako generalno je u tu ceremoniju bilo uključeno oko 4,000 ljudi.
400 temple guards.
400 stražara hrama.
And you know, they would tie a leg around that priest.
I znači, oni su zavezali,
a rope around his leg, okay, sorry.
Oni su zavezali, znači, odelo za njegovu nogu.
So that if he did anything wrong,
da bi vidjeli da li je nešto pogrešno.
They knew he was going to die right there in front of a holy God.
Ako nešto bude pogrešno, oni su znali da će on sigurno umreti pred svetim
Bogom. And then they'd have to pull him out dead.
Da, pardon, da, sad mi je jasno sve. Oni su zavezali uže oko njega, da. Uže oko njega jer su znali da ako nešto bude pogrešno, oni će ga morati mrtvoga izvući iz svetine na svetinu.
And the people that were watching, the people were allowed on the east side to watch this performance.
I ljudima je bilo dozvoljeno da priđu hramu sa istočne strane i da gledaju taj događaj.
And when that day happened,
i kada se dogodio taj dan,
everybody held their breath.
Svi su držali dah.
Everybody was in complete silence.
Svi su bili u potpunoj tišini.
Because they knew they had sin.
Jer su znali da su imali greh.
And the sin would have to be represented.
I taj njihov greh trebao je biti reprezentiran.
But if the priest himself died, then their sin would remain.
Ali ako bi taj sveštenik sam umro, onda bi njihov greh ostao.
It was a very tense time.
To je bilo jedno vrlo napeto vreme.
Because there was judgment in the balance.
Jer je tu, znači tu je bila sad sud u pitanju.
And when the priest
i kada je sveštenik
would walk in,
ušao,
and he would be accepted,
i on bi bio prihvaćen,
and they practiced this.
I oni su to vežbali stalno.
You don't turn around and walk out.
Ne može se tek okrenuti i samo izaći.
Then they made him practice walking backwards.
Onda su oni njega trenirali kako mora hodati u natraške.
Better not stumble.
I nemoj pasti.
And if he came back out,
i ako izašao van,
then he'd be accepted.
On je bio prihvaćen.
To take the sins of the people.
Da onda uzme grehe ljudi.
So then they bring the lamb.
I onda su doneli to janje.
And one would go free, you know the story.
I vi znate tu priču.
And then they would inspect him in front of all of the people.
I onda bi ga ispred svih tih ljudi pregledali.
And it was a big process.
I to je bio jedan jako velik proces.
And he had to be killed exactly the right way.
I morao je biti ubijen na tačno određen način.
And the blood had to be collected.
I ta krv je bila, trebalo je uhvatiti.
And now the people's sins were in question.
I sad su bili u pitanju gresi ljudi.
And he'd go behind one more time.
I on je otišao iza zavese još jednom.
And the prophet opens the mystery.
I prorok sad otvara tu tajnu.
And he takes the blood.
I uzima krv.
And sprinkles it seven times.
I on 7 puta
through seven church ages.
Znači, baci za sedam crkvenih doba.
Because now the priest is accepted.
Jer sada je sveštenik
and the blood has been accepted.
I sada je krv prihvaćena.
And has been applied.
I bila je aplicirana.
And then he takes that. There's a bunch more, but he takes it back out.
Toga, i sada on to vrati
and
nazad.
Then if he comes back out,
i sada ako se on vrati,
the people that are watching,
ljudi koji su
they
gledali,
can throw their hands up.
Oni su mogli dići ruke u zrak.
They can rejoice.
Mogli su se
they can go
veseliti.
Free.
Mogli su ići
their otići. Sins are taken care of for another year.
Za jednu
and God
godinu.
Has taken care of their sin
i Bog se pobrinuo
by the offering of the priest.
Za, znači, kroz tu žrtvu tog sveštenika.
And then Jesus came.
I onda je došao Isus.
And he was a perfect lamb.
I on je bio potpuno janje, perfektno
before the priest presented a lamb.
I prije nego što sveštenik prezentira jagnje.
Now he was the lamb.
Sada je on bio jagnje.
Now the spirit in Jesus.
Sada je duh u Isusu.
Could come back on us through the church, seven church ages.
Mogao se vratiti na nas koji služimo kroz sedam crkvenih doba.
But in the Old Testament.
Ali u starom zavetu.
If the spirit of the lamb came back on us.
Ako bi duh jagnje došao na nas.
We'd be eating grass.
Mi bi jeli travu.
Amen. But now Jesus was the lamb.
Ali sada Isus je bio to janje.
And his life was going to be sacrificed.
I njegov život će biti žrtvovan.
And he now went in front.
I sada je on išao.
After Calvary to be accepted.
Znači pred Golgotu da bude primljen.
And he came back.
I on se vratio.
To witness.
Da svedoči.
He was accepted.
Da je bio primljen. Amen.
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 But that didn't take care of our sin.
Ali to nije još bilo, znači to još nije pobrinulo za naše grehe.
But it did prove that he was accepted.
Nego je samo posvjedočilo da je
but
on
then
bio
Jesus
primljen.
Says in Acts.
Ali onda u apostolskim delima
he says I'm going to go to the Father.
Ja ću otići Otcu.
I'm going to go back to the holiest of holies.
Ja moram se vratiti u
svetinjama.
I onda
the
kaže,
way you see me go
način na kojeg vi vidite mene odlazi
is the way you're going to see me come.
Na taj način vi ćete me vidjeti.
And while you're on
vraćam,
this earth
i dok ste vi na toj
I'll
zemlji,
take the blood
ja ću uzeti krv
Jesus' blood, my Isusom blood
moju krv,
through seven church ages
sedam crkvenih
and
doba,
apply the blood for the people
za ljude,
and when that is finished
i kad će to biti
then
pri
I'm going to come back
onda ću se
the
ja
same way that I came
na na
to give you evidence
da vam dam dokaz,
that you
da ste vi,
your sins are forgiven.
Da su otpušteni.
And when he comes back, we can rejoice.
Mi se možemo veseliti.
We're free.
Mi smo slobodni.
We're free.
Slobodni.
We're free. Because he gave us evidence.
Jer nam je dao dokaz.
Something you can testify
nešto
to.
Nešto što vama svjedoči.
And I was wondering.
Ja sam se pitao.
Imagine what a sinner I would be today.
Zamisli kakav grešnik bi ja bio danas.
If I wouldn't be witness.
Ako ne bi bio svedok.
To Christ.
Krista.
Remember how Brother Branham said, that cloud.
Prisjetite se kako je brat Branham rekao, taj oblak.
It's a temporary resurrection is in the cloud. And I was pulled up.
Znači, privremeno uskrsnuće u tom oblaku, ja sam bio uzdignut.
Do you think that was for fun?
Zar mislite da je to bilo tek tako za
no.
šalu? Ne.
That was your down payment.
To je bio tvoja pretplata.
Your earnest.
Znači tvoja pretplata.
One day.
Jednog
you'll
dana.
Be pulled up.
Ti ćeš biti uzdignut gore.
He was pulled up.
Kao što je on bio uzdignut.
That's my earnest.
To je moja pretplata.
And now.
I sada.
Here comes that cloud.
Dolazi taj oblak.
And Brother Branham says, angels, birds.
Angeli, ptice.
Then he goes to Revelation 1.
I onda prolazi kroz otkrivenje
1. And he said, I was always wondering.
Ja sam se uvijek pitao.
The white wigged one.
Znači taj sa belom perikom.
I tried this and I tried that.
I pokušao sam ono.
That didn't make sense.
I ovo nije imalo smisla.
And all of a sudden he ended up in Revelation 1.
I odjednom on se zaustavlja na otkrivenju
1. And he said, take that picture.
I on kaže, uzmite tu sliku.
You're not looking at it right.
Vi je ne gledate pravilno. Amen.
Turn it.
Okrenite je.
Who do you see?
Koga sad vidite?
It's the judge.
To je sudac.
The white wig one.
Onaj sa belom perikom.
And now the judge is here.
I sada je sudac tu.
And because he's judge.
I zbog toga jer je on sudac.
Because he is judge.
Jer je on sudac.
He can say.
On može reći.
Juraš?
Uroš?
Not only do I pardon you.
Ne samo da ti ja opraštam.
Not only do I forgive you.
Ne samo da ti otpuštam.
But now,
nego sada,
I'm the judge.
Ja sam sudac.
I am the judge.
Ja sam sudac.
And I can take Uroš.
I ja mogu uzeti Uroša.
And I've got the mystery in the cloud to restore him.
I imam tajnu oblaka da ga obnovim.
Back!
Natrag.
To a full son.
Amen.
U puno vreme. And a full daughter of God.
U puno pravnu
čeru. Amen.
Amen.
You can forgive somebody, but he's still a sinner.
Vi možete otpustiti greh nekome, ali još uvijek grešnik.
But only God,
ali samo Bog,
the judge,
sudac.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Can pronounce.
Može izreći.
You're my daughter.
Ti si moja čer.
When the Son of Man returns, will I find faith.
Amen. Kada se Sin čovječi vrati, da li ću ja naći veru?
In the revealed body word of truth.
U otkriveno telo reči istine. Amen.
I can't go no more.
Ne mogu više nastaviti.
Amen. I pray.
Ja molim.
When you go to bed tonight,
kad idete večera spavat,
you're not the same here.
Da nećete više biti isti tu. Amen.
You're not the same here.
Da niste isti tu.
This is my desire.
Ovo je moja želja.
To honor you.
Koje su vam promakle u ovoj službi, jer se brat malo žurio.
Yes, I'm confident that maybe you lost some things during this service because our brother mentioned many things.
Ja, ali sigurno ako imate vremena neke stvari da proučite u Bibliji sami u poruci.
But for sure take your time and study some things in the Bible.
I mnoge stvari je napomenuo i stvorio samo okvir koji ima puno detalja, recimo Tamar je pričao.
And he mentioned many things which are actually just like a base, but there are many details inside, like Tamar, for example.
Da, i sigurno ćete uživati ako ne otkrijete te detalje ako vam i Bog otkrije.
And for sure you will enjoy or won't enjoy those things if the details are not
Ja to su službe kakve ja volim kad neko uzme tipove.
Personally, these are my favorite services when somebody takes a type.
I zanimljivo mi je, možete sjesti minutu.
And it's interesting, you can sit down for just a minute.
Imam imam jednu pjesmu koju bih htio otpjevati, ali kad ispričam ovo, znači će nešto drugo.
There is a song which I want to us to sing, but I'll first say this one and you'll understand it better.
Ja. Prije nego što smo došli na kamp, zadnje službe koje smo mi imali kod nas kući,
before we came to camp, last service we had at our home church.
Bila je tema o ognjenom stupu i oblaku u našem vremenu.
It was a theme of a cloud and a pillar of fire in our time.
I sad je brat to ponovo uzeo i zato me to jako blagoslovilo.
And our brother took that theme again and that's why it touched me so much.
I govorili smo na temu...
Mikrofon.
A, sorry. Govorili smo na temu...
Okay. Thank you.
Govorili smo na temu...
We were talking about...
O Božjem dolasku za dnevnog povjetarca u Edenu.
Znači when God came in the evening you know
cool the evening
the breeze yeah
in the Eden
yeah.
Često imamo svoje slike kako je to izgledalo.
And many times we can picture our own pictures how it looked like.
I sigurno bi svi voljeli biti tamo u tom trenutku.
And for sure we all want to be that at that moment there at that moment.
Možda nekom zamišlja Boga da je uzeo neko tijelo pa došao tamo.
And maybe somebody you know is thinking like God took certain body and came there.
Možda neko misli da je Bog progovorio iz vjetra.
Maybe somebody thinks that you know God spoke through breeze.
Ali ima jedan citat u poruci gdje Abraham kaže da je Bog dolazi u obliku ognjenog stupa.
But there is a quote in Brother Branham's message where Brother Branham said that God was coming in a pillar of fire.
I da je ognjeni stup se kretao između žbunja.
And that the pillar of fire was actually moving throughout the bushes.
I to je bilo u originalnom Edenu.
And that was in the original Eden.
Zar je neobično da u Sotoninom Edenu dođe na isti način?
Would it be something extraordinary if he would do the same thing in Satan's Eden, come into the pillar of
fire? I on je učinio istu stvar. U Sotoninom Edenu došao kao ognjeni stup.
So he's done the same thing here in Satan's Eden. He actually came as a pillar of fire.
I progovorio nama iz ognjenog stupa.
And he spoke to us through that pillar of fire.
I mi to zovemo porukom.
And that's what we call the message.
I kaže prorok, sve što je Mojsiju nedostajalo, ognjeni stup je imao.
And prophet says, whatever Moses was missing, pillar of fire had it all.
Sve što je Pavlu nedostajalo, imao je ognjeni stup.
Whatever Paul was missing, there was in that pillar of fire.
Sve što je Tamara trebala, Juda je imao.
Whatever Tamar needed, Judah had.
I sve što mi trebamo.
And whatever we need,
ova poruka ima.
This message has it all.
Ova poruka nije, što je brat rekao, ova poruka nije metodisti plus.
As the brother said, this message is not Methodist plus something.
Kao što ognjeni stup nije bio Mojsijevo teološko otkrivenje kad je ubio čovjeka plus.
Pillar of fire.
U vrijeme Mojsija, Mojsija je imao neko teološko.
Yeah, it wasn't some kind of theological thought about.
Kad je on ubio čovjeka, pa je onda još poruka ognjeni stup bio nešto malo više.
Yeah, yeah, like you know, he killed a man and then the message was you know, this plus something else.
Da, znači poruk ognjeni stup u vrijeme Pavla nije bilo Pavlovo židovstvo plus.
And so the pillar of fire or the message of Paul in the time wasn't Jewish tradition plus something else.
Recimo ako uzmemo Tamaru,
for example if we take Tamar,
Juda nije bio er ili onan plus.
Judah wasn't er ili or onan and something plus.
On je bio original.
He was the original.
I to je sve što mi trebamo.
And that's the only thing we need.
I to je poruka je ognjeni stup koji je progovorio.
And that is the message is actually a pillar of fire that spoke.
Znači oblak je sve što mi trebamo.
So the cloud is everything what we need, all we need.
Sve što nama fali tamo je.
So whatever we need, it's there.
Ako trebate vjeru za iscjeljenje, tamo je.
If you need your faith for healing, it's there.
Vjeru za uznesenje, tamo je.
Faith for rapture, it's there.
I neću odužiti. Ajmo opjevati pjesmu Vidjek svjetlo, ali misliti na to svjetlo, na ognjeni stup. Na...
Okay, let's sing a song, I saw the light, and think about this light.
This one.
Znači, službe posle podne su u 4, a zatišje je u 15:30. Tako. Obrnuto. Služba je u 4, je li tako? A zatišje je u 4, a služba je u 4:30. 16:30, tako. Tako, Bog vas blagoslovio, možemo da se razilazimo polako. Amen.